number 5, Evgeny Demin. Number 28, Thomas Munich.
Well, good evening, everyone. Sounds weird. What's wrong with that? Oh, there we go.
There we go.
That makes sense. Technical difficulties, you know the deal. Let's just act like we didn't hear this, okay? Welcome in, everybody, here to the David S. Palmer Arena. Danville Dashers taking on the Delaware Thunder here in FPHL action tonight. Of course you knew that. That's why you're here. A lot of fun in store tonight as we basically have a Dashers 2.0 team coming back to face Danville. Some old teammates going to reunite. Maybe some fisticuffs exchanged. We'll see. Delaware currently sitting at the bottom of the FPHL's Eastern Conference. The Dashers now moved up to second place in the Western Conference. Nate Williamson here with you. I'll be giving you a little bit of play-by-play, or at least my best attempt at it tonight. I'm joined by my partner, Mr. Dennis Michelson here. Dennis, Friday night, how you doing?
Oh my goodness, I'm excited to be here, Nate. We're back. We're back, and we've got 3 weekends in a row of great Danville Dashers hockey here at the David S. Palmer Arena. And while it's, of course, a lot of fun and entertaining to listen to you call the games, even better to come here in person and watch you call the games.
Yeah. People, I've actually seen them turn their chairs around from the ice to watch me instead of the game.
Absolutely,
before.
Man. Yeah, they no love doubt. Watching you in action.
That's what everybody's here for, right? There are some broadcasters that would definitely have you think that. Either way, we're here, a reunion of sorts, as I mentioned earlier, as we see Delaware come back into town. Plenty of familiar faces. Let's just go down the list here. Guys that are on the roster here for Delaware. Ryan Marker did not make the trip, but he was the Dashers' leading point scorer last season despite leaving the team halfway through and not returning. He did refuse a call back and was suspended indefinitely, but came back and was drafted. His rights came back and were granted by the FPHL to play with the Delaware Thunder during the expansion draft process. And Ryan, someone I got to work with a lot last year, a great guy, very friendly, a great hockey player. I'm kind of sad that he's not going to be here tonight, and so is Delaware. He's currently their leading point getter and by a pretty wide margin, Dennis. And we've also got guys like Taylor Cutting, a fan favorite, as well as Alex Basie, who is not active tonight as far as we know here. Charlie Penns Jr., a former Dasher, played a lot of games last season for Danville. His dad, of course, the coach of this Delaware team and was drafted in the expansion draft. Also, Aaron Taylor, the starting goaltender for Delaware, the Dashers goaltender last season, behind Matt Kalutis, of course. So Aaron Taylor, one of two goaltenders that were a Dasher last season that we'll see tonight. And, of course, Matt Kalutis no longer with the Dashers, so won't be seeing any of him. Brian Dunford was on the Dashers as well. And that will about do it. That long list there, Dennis. But nonetheless, what's it like, do you think, coming back to a team and playing on what used to be your home ice, playing against guys that you were teammates, you were brothers, you were friends with? How does that affect you coming into a game?
Yeah, I've got to believe that they want to show that they are on the wrong team, maybe. You know, that they've got what it takes to be still here in Danville. But you know, this is going to be really interesting tonight to see how this Delaware team reacts to playing the Dashers. The Dashers much improved from last year, and of course, Delaware's been struggling this season. So it will be real interesting to see. And I have a feeling the first 3 or 4 minutes of the game will set the mood on what we're going to see as a style of play here at the David S. Palmer Arena tonight.
Yeah, no doubt. In my weekend preview, we got on the website, danvilledashers.com, this morning. One of the keys of the game, I thought, was getting Aaron Taylor off and unsettled early in the game, in the early few minutes. He can really get into a groove. We saw it a couple of times last year, a couple of stellar performances, and that's why he was selected in the expansion draft from the Dashers. And, man, he can really get into it. So you want to try and score early, often throw him off as quickly as you can.
And on the other side of the ice, man, it is great to see Jesse Gordichuk. I was fearful that when he got called up that he would not be coming back. But sadly for him, he never got a chance to play for Birmingham. Just, a replacement to sit on the bench in case something happened. I wish they would have given that kid a chance. I think they would have been surprised.
Yeah, no doubt. The SPHL has been riddled with injury problems so far this season, and we haven't seen our fair share of that recently, but earlier on in the season, we had just about the same problem. But now looking up at the Bud Light skybox, and not as many people stationed up there as we've grown accustomed to earlier on in the season, and thankful for it. We'd like both of these teams to be at full strength coming into tonight. Well, welcome to Dishman Inflatables Kids Night as well. The next Kids Night coming up in about a month, a little bit more than that, a month and 2 weeks on February 14th. Kids get in free with an adult ticket. Of course, tomorrow night, we do have a very fun night planned for you, our Cartoon Faith and Family Night presented by Robinson Chiropractic. You're going to want to make it out to see us. The only acceptable reason to not be watching this broadcast, you're here. That's the only reason. And some people even watch it while they're here, which is kind of funny to me. I never would have expected that, but I'll take it. I'll never say no to more people watching the stream, that's for sure.
Absolutely. And when is Country Night coming up, man? When is that coming up? I got the bib overalls all clean. They're pressed. They're ready for action.
You'll be happy to know that's a week from today, coming up on February 7th. That is our first Country Night, and it is presented by somebody that I've gotten to know really, really well. I know you've gotten to interact with a fair share of times, too, from the Vermilion County Farm Bureau. All the guys out there, we interact with them daily in my day job. We love them, and we're thankful they came together to sponsor a night tonight. It's also sponsored by our friends over at B&J Music. Man, they've been around since I was a kid, and even longer. I've been buying musical instruments, guitar picks, a lot of instruments that I never learned how to play and was never any good at.
Yeah, that's why they do the musical instrument rentals. So after you realize you can't play a lick, you can return it after the rental program's over.
Took full advantage of that program, although one time I did make the mistake of buying my own. I think it's collecting dust in my closet right now, but that's not surprising, and it's not what we're here to talk about anyway. In lesser words, come out and see Country Night. I'm going to give you our starting lineup here tonight. That's a courtesy of Danville Township, established in 1851. Your favorite township. That's an unofficial slogan, but I just gave it to him because you know what? I have that kind of power. Starting lineup tonight for Danville, Tyler Quintos going to be in the forward slot along with the leading goal scorer and point getter, Mr. Fred Hine. Sam Turner also going to be out there. Jesse Gordichuk in net, as we mentioned earlier. The defensive pairing there is Seth Ensor. And we can only imagine that A.J. Tesorero is going to be slotting back just a little bit to play in more of a defensive role on the evening, as there is four forwards planned for tonight. On the other side of the ice, Evgeny Demin in the forward spot wearing number 5. Thomas Municiello also out there for Delaware in the forward spot. Charlie Penns Jr., the former Dasher, getting the start here in his homecoming. Anthony Pisano at the defensive spot as well. Aaron Taylor in goal, and Mark Anthony Simonetta at the forward spot for Delaware. I turn you over to Mr. Tommy B. for your Danville starting lineup. St. Louis native Sam Turner, the first one out of the tunnel. St. Louis Blues also in action tonight. Seems appropriate. There's Seth Ensor coming out as well. Tyler Quintos coming out now, one of the newer additions for the Stasher team this season. I'd say it's paid off, to say the least. And, of course, you can't mention the Danville Dashers without mentioning that man right there, Mr. Fred Hine from Boston, Massachusetts. And coming out, A.J. Tesorero, player coach and an impact player to say the least. We've seen him do some dazzling things with a stick so far this season. And of course, talk about dazzling, some of the performances put on this season by Mr. Jesse Gordichuk, the Penticton, British Canada native. I don't know if I pronounced that right. I don't know Canada very well. And of course, probably the most important person out there skating out during the starting lineups, the youth player spotlight for Danville Township, Augustine Zaragoza from the Danville Junior Dashers. Love that organization, love what they do. Dennis on the other side of the ice, really quick before we get into the national anthem. Actually, when we come back, I'll have you talk about your impact player, maybe from Delaware tonight, with Ryan Marker being out. We take a break here for the national anthem.
Oh, say can you see? What so proud?
twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watch, were so gallantly streaming.
Kirk Kaiser with your United States National Anthem there as we get ready for Friday night hockey action here at the David S. Palmer Arena. Already pestering the referees. That seems like a Danville crowd move. I have seen that plenty of times over the past couple of years. And, you know, as a referee, before we get into some relevant things, I feel like they kind of love that. Like, I feel like that would really put me like, okay, I'm going to do my best to make you sound stupid, like yelling at me like that. I don't know. I could never be a referee either way.
Referees need to have very small ears to not be able to let them get riled up by the crowd. And, you know, what we've seen this year in the Federal Prospects Hockey League is we've seen a lot of great games called where they've let a lot of this end-to-end action go. And that's what I love to see, and a big improvement than having so many stoppages of play. So they've done a great job this year.
Yeah, no doubt. Well, we're about to get ready here at the puck drop. Maybe some impact players from tonight. Dennis, we've got guys like Bryce Lidke there in the defensive role. Obviously, Aaron Taylor going to play a huge part in this game down at the other end of the ice. Thoughts, opinions, feelings, post-mortem statements, you know.
If there's one weakness of this Danville Dashers team, even during their quest in rising to second place, it's they're just not putting enough pucks in the net yet. And that makes Aaron Taylor the big key tonight for Delaware.
Faceoff won by Danville, but not controlled, as that one's thrown all the way back into their own defensive end. It's eventually picked up by Gordichuk, sent down the side there by Evgeny Demin. This one comes out to the point to Delaware, a flopping shot that just went wide right of the goal of Jesse Gordichuk, now collected by Tyler Quintos. He looks to find Fred Hine with a high one there. Instead, Hine ties the stick as Danville going to try and keep this in. They fail, and Delaware gets the puck. Coming up now, number 12 there, rolling through Delaware as they come up. A shot fired, and we have our first shot of the night that came off the stick of number 32, Charlie Penns Jr., the former Dasher, and is promptly swallowed up by Mr. Jesse Gordichuk.
Another good, solid start for Jesse and Nat, just making those nice, easy saves. On those first shots this year, he's been solid.
Yeah, and if they're going to throw them at you, you might as well catch the easy ones, get into a groove, and it's always dangerous. Goalies are such rhythmic people, you know. They just can get going on you. Justin Brousen tied up in the corner there on the other side with number 55, Kieran Devine. Danville elects to play it behind their net now. That one turned over dangerously in the Dasher area. No one can really get a firm stick on the puck right now. Comes all the way out there to Troy Murray, who tries to push it forward. Instead, it gets back to Devine, dangerously hopping past the left of Jesse Gordichuk, fighting for it behind the goal now, both sides. Ending up with it was Taylor Cutting, the former Dasher. He throws that one out, and a big old hit there on the right side, and we're going to have a stoppage.
We're going to have our first penalty of the night.
We'll see who that one is assessed to. I didn't see anything that looked particularly.
It's a slash.
It was
a slash on Delaware.
And that's going to come back. And you do wonder if that's going to go. Looks like it's going to go on number 3, Evan McIntosh there. As he sees our first Jenna Worth power play.
No hesitation at all by the referee. So he definitely had a good view of that one.
That is a quick start to the game and a way to kind of assess that, hey, we're going to play clean hockey here. If you saw a slash, and the referee fully in charge and letting it known.
Well, I think there is a little bit of a concern going into tonight of this game getting a little rough. And so I think the referees are going to call a pretty tight game here and try to keep a little order here at the David S. Palmer Arena.
And, you know, I was just thinking about it. I think I've seen movies similar to this storyline where a bunch of guys from a team end up on another team and go over, and they're playing for this new team. They come back and challenge the team that's doing a little bit better maybe and replaced with new guys coming into the year. You kind of see that storyline every once in a while when you are watching maybe like a Disney movie. I don't know. But seems like things could get out of hand. But for the most part, just from interacting with most of these guys last year, I would say that the friendships are still there. I mean, guys like Taylor Cutting were loved by this franchise. So it'll be interesting to see how those chemistries go together as Danville wins the faceoff and Sam Turner grabs it at the left defenseman spot. Flared through to Tesserero, who pushes it back out to Turner. Turner over to Fred Hine. Hine fires a shot off the boot there of Pisano. And Danville able to recover with it. It's back to Tesserero. Hine on it now. Hine fires a shot. It's deflected. It comes back to him. Hine on it now on the left side. Back to Turner. Turner back to Hine. Hine with a shot. Rockets off a stick and off a face there as Delaware able to clear the zone. And that puck comes all the way back to Matt Kalutis. Or Jesse Gordichuk. Even I'm stuck in 2018, I suppose it would be, actually. Danville elects to collect this one as they come down the ice. No time up on the scoreboard for us right now.
I think that's the discussion that the referees were having with the coaches there and why we heard that horn to call the referees over.
That makes sense. We got 2 minutes here one way or another. We'll let you know when that fifth player comes out. Trying to set it up there was Danville. Instead, Delaware going to get it out, and it's cleared by number 55, Kieran Devine. Back behind the puck was Murray. As Danville attacking down the right-hand side. Trying to make a move here. Fired up back in front of the goal. They're going to have it to the right there of Taylor. Now back to the point. Passing it around here, Danville, as they wait for their offensive opportunity here on the Genoworth power play. To the right side, a sneaky little pass there is intercepted nicely by Delaware. On it there was Daniel DeCristofaro. This one shot back down the ice, and Delaware doing a good job so far on this penalty kill. They're going to have to get back out here quickly, though. No stretch pass attempted. Waiting for it, there was number 77, Artem Efimov-Barakov. Quintos coming down the middle of the ice here. Fakes to the left. Passes it back to Armstrong. Armstrong fires one up wide and high there of Aaron Taylor.
I think there's 3 seconds left on the penalty, according to our referee coming over to tell the coaches.
Looks like it. You wonder, that's a brand new scoreboard there. You don't want to see it broken. Things happen, though. They definitely do, as we're going to get a face-off here to the right of Aaron Taylor, taking it for Delaware's Brian Dunford. Patrick Zalak on the other side. Won by Dunford and thrown out to the man coming out of the penalty box. Delaware looking threatening here down the left side. And losing the puck there, and just able to be tripped up by the Danville defenseman, Brad Denny, on the coverage there. Looked like it was going to be Brennan Young that had an opportunity. Instead, sorted out by Brad Denny. Now coming back, a tough shot there, a tight angle saved up by Jesse Gordichuk. That came off the stick of Brian Dunford.
Delaware really putting a lot of pressure on the Dashers in their defensive zone. All five players for Delaware were well within inside the blue line when the Dashers had the puck. So look for one of these long stretch passes to get an odd man break for the Dashers here if they can beat that Delaware pressure.
It's interesting to see Brian Dunford taking center faceoffs here for Delaware. Not something we saw him do a whole lot, as he is a defenseman, but maybe playing a combo role here for Delaware, and it's worked so far. He's won some key ones in that power play, which has now been killed by the Delaware Thunder. Penalty kill doing a good job in Danville. Going to run down for this one. It's Mitch Atkins. Oh, a nice pass out there. Almost finds Tesserero. Broken up, though, by Delaware. Coming back behind this one now. Dunford passes it along the boards. He was looking for number two, Ryan Kerr. And this one's going to come all the way back for an icing, as we're going to see a face-off here in the Delaware defensive zone. Early impressions, Dennis, here as we head towards the 16:08 mark of the first period.
Well, Danville's definitely had the edge on the offense, but really you've great passing, but not many good opportunities to take a shot on the net. A lot of traffic in front of that
net. A rocket there from Fred Hine from the left side of our screen here. Instead, Delaware able to come back from it as it was high of Aaron Taylor. Grabbing that behind the net there was Seth Ensor. Fred Hine back to Ensor. Ensor collects behind the net. He's pressured there by Evgeny Demin. Danville able to flip this one in as Fred Hine goes in for a shift change. It's picked up by Delaware's defenseman there, number 86, Brennan Young, actually coming in from the forward spot to grab that one. Young going to fight for this one now as he wins it. Haugud applies the defensive pressure, and it's broken up by Murray. Referee getting tangled up a little bit in there. Delaware going to have to reset or face an offside here. They reset, bring it back through their defensive zone. Flipped up, trying to find number 44, Mark Anthony Simonetta. Instead, it's back till the Danville Dashers defense. Bringing it out of the zone here is Danville. Coming up the left-hand side, Justin Brousen finds the foot of Nayer. That one's going to be blown back for an offside.
Yeah, number 8, Mitch Atkins on the near side here was just a little ahead of the play there.
It's always tight inches, I would say, in the offside category. It's true in every sport where there is offside, in all honesty, but nonetheless, a face-off here as we go by the blue line on the left side of your radio dial, we should say. And it's won by Danville. Back to Murray, who fires a slap shot. It was actually touched up nicely there by Simonetta, but instead comes all the way back to Delaware. Coming up the other side with a nice stick move, Thomas Municiello, as that puck gets fired back behind the net of Gordichuk, and Danville going to try and work the other way with it. Delaware does a nice job of keeping it in the zone, though. One stick by Brousen has Danville on the move down the right-hand side. A nice move by Jesse Nayer as he's in space. Nayer tries to find an open net there for Justin Brousen, but some nice defensive effort from Delaware sees that threatening attack come to the end. Now behind the net here, Delaware able to recollect. Coming back on at number 55, Kieran Devine. Already had an impressive night on the defensive side. This one turned over, though, coming out of the other side. Ensor. Ensor fires a shot to the left of Aaron Taylor. Taylor not really tested too much here in the early goings. Not a whole lot of shots on net. A lot of shots, though. Nick Gullo on the back end here on the left defensive side. His pairing with Brad Denny, as that was number 9, Brent Menton, getting the ice under his skates in his first home appearance for Danville. Oh, and Gordichuk has to seal the right side of his goal. Delaware really threatening here in the early going. And a hard pass looking for somebody in front of the net. Actually finds somebody back at the blue line, and Delaware going to have to reset. Gordichuk had no idea where the puck was there as that one flopped into his arms. Good reaction there by Gordichuk. He was screened from just about every angle. And Danville able to finally calm things down here with 13:36 left to go in the first period. This one popped up. Looked like it might have been coming up to us. Instead falls back down on the ice and is played into the Delaware zone. Lots of quick hockey here tonight. Not a lot of breaks so far, but we're going to see one there as that one goes all the way down for an icing.
During warm-ups tonight, it was kind of interesting. I saw a couple of the Delaware players who used to be Dashers kind of showing the other players on the team just how sensitive some areas of the boards are as they were firing the pucks around during warm-ups.
Face-off won by Danville onto the goal of Aaron Taylor and swatted out all the way back to the Danville defense. Instead, Fred Hine going to get it first and throw it back around. Taylor comes out of his net to grab it, unable to catch up with it, and it comes all the way back around to Sam Turner on the left-hand defensive side. Turner floating back into left defense for the evening as a big-bodied forward, a scoring defenseman, I would call him if he's back in the defenseman slot. As he throws this one down, it looks like he's going to go in for a shift change. Out comes Logan Haugud in exchange for him. Delaware comes down the ice here, followed by the play of Daniel DeCristofaro. Fires a rocket shot off of Gordichuk, who has to swallow that one up. DeCristofaro, one of the top scorers on this Delaware team, and a rocket of the shot shows you exactly why.
Very interesting start to this game, because I would have thought that the Dashers would take the offensive game to Delaware a little stronger than they are.
I think they would have liked to, but Delaware instead, the threatening ones here, is that one's picked up by Evgeny Demin. Right in front of goal now, a shot is swallowed up by Jesse Gordichuk off the stick of Municiello.
Birmingham might be thinking about wanting him back. Keeps playing like this.
As now we have a face-off to his right here. It's won by Danville, but threatening is Delaware. Nicely touched up there. Delaware with an opportunity. The hustle play there was number 44, Simonetta.
Once again, Gordachuk getting over there to seal that near side.
Danville seemingly unable to clear this puck in any way as Simonetta threatening behind the goal tries to pick a pass out to number 28, Municello. Instead, Danville coming the other way with it. On it here is Nick Gullo. Actually, Jesse Nayer wraps it around the backhand side. Coming the other way with it, Delaware, as that one was fired wide. Shot back behind the net of Gordachuk here. Is Murray going to try and play it? He does and hits the ice there. I think that was Taylor Cutting. Actually, Kieran Devine actually hits the ice there. As this one's gloved out of the air by Jesse Gordachuk. My, oh my, he's had to work often and hard tonight. And that shot from Evgeny Demin nearly found the top left corner of his net. Instead, glove saved by Gordachuk. How many times have we seen him do that?
Man, he's just got that quick glove. And I think one of the things we're seeing tonight, Nate, is missing Palmerville and Ben Bucall. It's really hurting the effectiveness of the Dashers getting the puck out of their own zone.
You certainly don't like to miss one of your starting defensemen, nonetheless missing two of them here as we go into the early part of the weekend. Nick Gullo coming down the right-hand side now after a nice stretch of passing by Danville. Loses it up. He's pressed along the boards and onto the ice now, but Danville able to recover from it. Hard pass off the stick of Gullo. A hustle play there. Nick Gullo, what a beaut. That one almost redirected in by Zalak. He's taken down cleanly. Delaware going to regroup with this one. An errant touch off the stick of Evan McIntosh sees Danville get it back, but on the other end, Delaware recollects again. They're coming down now through number 20, Taylor Cutting. The former Dasher was able to hold on to that one along the boards. And he stumbles off just a little bit. Looks to be okay. Continues. This one out to the point for Delaware. Cutting trying to get something in front of the net. He can be really threatening when he's in front of the net, Dennis. Now come the other way. A nice block there from Danville. Blocking on that one was number 9, Brent Metton. Oh, almost an opportunity there as Cutting was caught coming off the ice. Quintos on it now down the left side. A fought. As that shot is shaved off by Aaron Taylor. And this one redirected from a point shot from Seth Ensor up and out of play.
Boy, Delaware was in the middle of a change and didn't see the puck coming up from behind them. And the next thing you know, Dashers had a big opportunity, but again, could not cash in. Taylor making the stop, gave up the rebound, but nobody home.
Delaware going to have a two-on-two here if they move fast. They're working there through number 86, Brennan Young, as he loses up the puck. Some nice defense there from Danville. Finds a nice pass there to number 59, Brian Dunford, but unable to capitalize as Danville comes the other way with it now. A stretch pass there is going to find this one as Ensor. He tries to dump it backwards. It's a turnover as well. A little bit of sloppy play here with 10:16 left to go in the first period. Delaware definitely having the majority of the offensive opportunities here so far. As Danville looking to get a foothold here, tries to find Fred Hine out of the defense, does Seth Ensor. Instead, dumped down by Delaware. Offside waved off here as Danville able to look at it and run. Quintos passes this outlet to Fred Hine, who grabs it. Hine to Quintos. Quintos got some room on the left-hand side. Instead, it's turned over, and it comes to Eric Masters. I'm sorry. Actually, that was Thomas Municiello. Should know better. Now coming the other way, A.J. Tesserero, he's got a 1-on-3. We've seen him beat the odds a couple of times. He tries to do that there, but some nice defense from the big Anthony Pisano knocks him off the puck.
Middle of a shift change for the Dashers, so not much that he could do with the puck there.
Simonetta coming the other way with it here. A nice outlet pass to the backward side of the goal. Instead, Danville going to try and get this one back. It's pushed down nicely by Brian Dunford instead. Danville able to recover, but Delaware threatening with some quick skating here and a lot of offensive pressure. Another shot here from the right-hand side, bouncing dangerously past Taylor. That one redirected up to a shin pad. Dangerous sight there for Aaron Taylor as he freezes that puck up.
Good opportunity as that puck started hippity-hopping in front of the net. And we almost saw Justin Brousen cash in there as he was finding. The puck kind of found him in the right spot there, Nate.
Yeah, he was there and a poacher in the truest words. He was there and ready to capitalize on it. And right now, a shirt toss here during the media timeout as we're, it's a good night here in Danville for a Friday night. Saturday is when we would expect probably the bigger crowd to be around. Should be a lot of fun here heading into the weekend homestand. A lot of familiar faces, like we've been saying all night, from this Delaware team coming back into the area. You like to see that. And you like to see the guys come back, some fan favorites. I'm sure we will see Taylor Cutting drop the gloves at some point in this weekend tonight. As we see him, if I had to pick, I would say it's probably going to be against Levi Armstrong here on the weekend. Two guys that were friends, and, you know, that always helps when it comes to throwing the gloves with the other person in a good way. Maybe not in a mean way, but you see a lot of that, especially here. There was a time in the FPHL, I don't know if they'll like me saying this on the air, so if I get cut off, that's why. They did. There were two players who were suspended indefinitely for having a reunion on the ice and pulling beers out of their jerseys and drinking. So we've come a long way in the history of the FPHL, let me tell you that. But just speaking of reunion, that's the first thing that comes to mind. Looks like we might be assessed a penalty here. There is still penalty up on the board, and the referee explaining something to both sides. But no one in the box, so no one going there, as both sides at full strength would appear as though the scoreboard is having a little malfunction here tonight.
I think we continue to have some scoreboard issues.
I'm sure the scoreboard worked all week until tonight.
Oh, yeah.
I have no doubt about it. Fired along the boards there. Cutting is going to try and get this one out. Comes as far as Browsen, who takes a little bit of a hit here, coming down the other side. Delaware played by Aaron Taylor dangerously there. Danville really threatening along the boards here as they look to up the tempo. But Delaware still keeping a good control of the possession of the puck. Charlie Penns Jr. coming down the right side here. Turned over to Jesse Nayer. Nayer's got a little bit of space, a one-on-one. Nice stick move. Oh, just barely broken up there by number 92. That was Jordan Clark. And Aaron Taylor falls on that one. Danville seemingly to get the best opportunities that they've had here in the past couple of minutes, and still not looking like a whole lot. Delaware's defense doing a great job at getting some legs under Aaron Taylor here on home ice. And in his return, he's doing a great job so far tonight. Hasn't been tested a whole lot. On the other hand, Jesse Gordachuk has been tested quite a bit so far this evening. Thrown off of the faceoff there is Brian Dunford. And on to it, Charlie Penns. Scratch that, Ryan Kerr on that one. This far in the jersey, some teams still don't have names on the back of their jerseys. Funny how that works, isn't it? Oh, Nick Gullo hit hard there. A nice hit by Ryan Kerr as this puck is fought for along the side, and Kerr ends up with it. Good hustle play there from him as he slings this one out to the left side and finds Kieran Devine. Another big hit laid there as we're going back and forth now at the David S. Palmer Arena. Oh, a shot from the right-hand side. Young with an opportunity and almost a rebound shot there by Brian Dunford. Instead, Danville coming down the right-hand side with a little bit of space. We have a delayed offside and an offside. As just a little bit too eager on the mismatch was Patrick Zalak.
Puck kind of took a little rolling hop over the stick of the Dashers forward and got his other line mate just barely offside there.
Delaware wins the corresponding faceoff and comes back along with it. It's played there to Daniel DeCristofaro, who plays it up to number 32, Charlie Penns. DeCristofaro there on it. And that one played there to Evgeny Demin. This one played up, trying to play off of it. Instead, it's Danville coming. A nice stick by Municiello keeps it going the other way. Sam Turner is able to collect it in the end, and Danville unable to get this one out of their defensive zone despite Delaware giving it to him three times in a row. And Delaware ends up with it. Now coming the other way with it, number 44, Simonetta. Out to the point. A shot from the point is blockered away by Jesse Gordachuk. Evgeny Demin on it now. Instead, Gordachuk freezes a shot down to his right-hand side, right in the glove. No problem for Jesse Gordachuk.
Very weird feel to this game tonight, Nate. It's just like the Dashers haven't quite got their offensive legs under them yet.
Kind of feels like a preseason game for both sides. Unable to capitalize on opportunities and not a whole lot of opportunities in general. Delaware, of course, seeing the majority of the ones that have been. And they're pressing on the offensive side. And that's a good heads up there from head coach Charlie Penns Sr. Danville come the other way with it. Atkins lays it off. A shot fires wide right from Mitch Atkins. As Delaware now come the other way down the left-hand side. It's a three-on-three if they move fast. Instead, Danville gets reset. This one going to leak out to the Danville offenseman. There's Jesse Nayer coming the other way with it. Nayer down the left-hand side. Gets past one. Unable to get past two. Gets the puck back, though. And then loses it up again there. A nice defensive effort from number 92, Daniel DeCristofaro. Nayer on it now. He's got Atkins out there to the right. Aaron Taylor instead swallows up the pass. Might have rode right into that right blocker and ends up in the glove of Aaron Taylor.
Yeah, another inch or two over in front of Aaron Taylor, and that's a pass right on the stick for the Dashers and a real good chance. But once again, Aaron Taylor read that play and snuffed it out.
6:34 left to go here in the first period. Nick Gullo tied up on that faceoff. It ends up in Barakov's stick. He's going to pass this one out to the point. Barely kept in there by Danville as that was Hoggood on it. Danville unable to communicate on that one. Gullo has it down the right-hand side. Tries to make a move. Instead gets lost in the tangle of legs. And Danville fighting hard to get this puck. That's Patrick Zalak laying a hit onto the side there as Gullo ends up with it again. Gullo back out to the point to Hoggood. Hoggood fires a shot wide left as it's tipped up there. Hey, a huge high hit into the boards. Danville still pressing on the offensive zone as right back up bounces Barakov. Barakov on it now in the left corner. Took a big shot there, but bounces right back up. Definition of a hockey player move right there. Delaware with it now as that one's passed all the way up to Ryan Kerr. Kerr loses it, though, and it ends up with Gullo. Gullo hands it off Armstrong right there. Instead, it turns over to Delaware, comes right down the left-hand side to Jesse Gordachuk's stick. Murray on it now. He fires a lead-out point to Armstrong. Armstrong loses it up, and it comes right back to where it started out at, to Murray. Murray on it now, coming, bringing it across the Dasher blue line. Instead, turned over sloppily there to Simonetta, who fires it down the ice. Right back to Gordachuk. Man, he's getting a leg workout tonight. A long stretch pass there to Atkins. We'll see if he gets to it. Icing waved off, of course, and he does get to it first, but is quickly upended there by Kieran Devine. A nice thought there on the lead pass from Jesse Gordachuk. Instead, it's turned over here, and Justin Brousen passes it off to Jesse Nayer. Instead, it comes back to number 44 there, Mark Anthony Simonetta. Fighting for it, Justin Brousen. It's turned over to Nayer, and back to Brousen. Brousen with a backhanded advance pass there. Turned over once again, and we're going to actually have an offside again, probably the fourth or fifth on the night for Danville. And that's been a problem for them so far tonight. Dennis, how do you go about fixing that problem when it comes to being offside all the time?
Well, what we've seen is the Dashers trying to anticipate the play, and then the puck just doesn't cooperate, and next thing you know, you're offside by just a couple of feet.
Tesserero with a shot here on Aaron Taylor. Rebound almost put in there. Instead, it's out to Delaware. Coming down the right-hand side here, number 23, Eric Masters, the former Dasher, gets past two, trying to go past a third, but it's whistled back for offside. Plenty of those being blown so far tonight, huh?
Boy, I didn't see that one.
A nice handy move there by Eric Masters. Maybe the move part of the reason it was offside. Good to see him back in Danville as well. Somebody who has a great hockey story and a great guy to talk to if you ever get the opportunity. Highly encourage it as Taylor Cutting and him, both of the former Dashers, out on the ice right now. Danville brings this one behind the net. Masters with a hustle play there. Ends up, that was a little bit of a sloppy skate there. Danville.
Look out.
Oh, a huge save there from Jesse Gordachuk. Delaware on top of it. Just an errant pass that ends up with a great opportunity for Delaware. Tyler Quintos bringing it down the side here. We're going to get a shift change. Instead, it comes over to Hine, though. Hine going to try and make something out of nothing here. Carries it along behind the boards as he's still got a hold of it. Instead, he's stripped off there. Number 86, Brennan Young, taking the puck away from him as that one comes all the way back to Jesse Gordachuk. A long stretch pass there. Nobody home, though, for Gordachuk, trying to connect with Fred Hine. A long slap shot fired high of the goal of Jesse Gordachuk. Barakov back with it now. Tries to find Brad Denny, but it takes a hop over the stick, and Brad Denny ends up with it anyway. Now coming back the other way, Barakov. Barakov fires a wrister high of Aaron Taylor. Fighting for it here along the near boards. Taylor comes way out of his net to try and grab that one. Instead, played by Delaware's defense, it comes and finds Kieran Devine in the end. Come the other way with it is Delaware. And that one fired wide right of the goal of Jesse Gordachuk as Levi Armstrong ends up with it. A swiping attempt at it there by Barakov. Instead, he elects to go for a shift change. Nick Gullo quick out of the box and lays a hit down at the other end of the ice, but nonetheless, Delaware coming the other way with the puck. Murray's got it behind the net now as he circles around. A nice play there. Delaware in on net. And luckily right there, Jesse Gordachuk able to get a blocker around as Mitch Atkins hustles in and sees the threat taken out. He's still got it after holding off a man in an arm bar. He's got a little space, finds Nayer. Nayer with a high shot. He hits the Gatorade bottle off the net and somehow stays out of the net. I have no idea how that happened, Dennis.
That was crazy. That puck just barely missing the near side upper corner of the net.
It's one thing to hit the Gatorade bottle in the net, the goaltender's best friend other than the poles, but to hit it above the net, that's an impressive feat. That's a game of inches right there. That shot from the right-hand side off of DeMitt ends up in the glove of Jesse Gordichuk, and we're going to see a little scrappy action here on the right-hand side of the goal of Jesse Gordichuk.
Give you one guess who was involved for the Dashers.
Oh, yeah, clearly seen there. It was Troy Murray in on it. On the other end, it was Thomas Municiello. At first, I thought it was Taylor Cutting, which is kind of why I waited to say anything about it. Instead, Cutting out there on the ice now, playing a little bit on the left wing here tonight. Towards the end of last season, started to get a groove and scored a couple really nice goals for Danville, something we weren't accustomed to seeing him doing, but we'll see if he can do that again tonight, feeling himself back on his former home ice. Instead, it's Quintos who passes to Hine, coming on the right-hand side. He's got help, passes it to Quintos. Quintos lays it off to Turner. Turner with a wrister shot, trying to redirect it there was Zalak. Instead, it's swallowed up nicely by Aaron Taylor with 2:09 left to go here in the first period.
Coach trying to get something going here, mixing and matching. Seeing Fred Hine out there with his usual running mate of Quintos, but now with Zalak out there as the third forward.
Zalak out there in the forward, and former forward Sam Turner out there on the defense spot as well. Something we haven't seen him do a whole lot this season at home. A new test, and it never hurts to have an extra guy who can score out there, I'll tell you that much. This one redirected by Fred Hine behind the net of Aaron Taylor, going to be picked up nicely there. And that was Charlie Penns on the other end of it. He fires a pass along the boards. McIntosh fires it over on the left side. Jesse Gordichuk, glove save on Taylor, cutting that one out of play.
Wow.
What a pass.
Big, great pass and a big stop by Jesse Gordichuk, because the Danville Dashers defense kind of a little lazy on that one. Sam Turner got beat here on the near side. Then a great pass. Next thing you know, it's all alone on Gordy, but it came up strong again.
Not their best moment, but not hurt from it, as Taylor Cutting shot is saved by Jesse Gordichuk. We've seen that a couple of times, I would say. This one played by Delaware back in their defensive zone. Going to have a 2-on-2 if they move fast. Trying to run through the right-hand side here with Brennan Young. It comes all the way back. A shot from the right-hand side off the stick of number 59, Brian Dunford. Off the foot there of Levi Armstrong. It's going to be a race between Aaron Taylor and Barakov. And Taylor wins out and passes it down the ice.
Smart play by Taylor.
Some quick thinking there, literally on his feet, as Levi Armstrong gets this one along the boards and fires it down. Trying to lay a hit there was Ryan Kerr, but Armstrong kind of just shrugged that one off, and Kerr actually eats the ice. I wouldn't try and hit Levi Armstrong. It is a good thing to try and do, though, I suppose. Now coming the other way with it through number 15, Bryce Littke. Delaware threatening here as we have 55 seconds left to go here in the first period. Littke carries it around, tries a nice backwards pass, instead broken up there by Brad Denny. Now it comes out here to number 9, Brett Menton, making his home debut. A nice stretch pass there by Justin Brousen. How about that? Brousen holds off a man, fires a hard shot off the pad of Aaron Taylor. Brousen with it again. In space was Brent Menton, but it's just nicely broken up there by Simonetta, who comes down the right-hand side. A pass in front of net. A big hit there by Danville. Keeps him off of it. Some wide-open hockey here in the last 50 seconds. 25 left to go. Jesse Nayer fights for it, gets it back. It comes to Atkins. Atkins on the right-hand side. A pass. Oh, almost redirected in. Aaron Taylor just does enough to throw that one off to his left. Atkins ends up with a rebound here. Atkins wraps around. He's looking for a pass. Delaware doing a great job of filling holes. Oh, a wrist shot there, backhanded wrist there as Brousen was hawking for it. Taylor sprawls out, doesn't know where it is, but it's somewhere underneath him. And the puck is blown dead as we've got 2.4 seconds left to go in the first period. These last 50 seconds, probably the most offense that we've seen all night.
Boy, that puck taking some weird bounces. That little pass that came off the boot. And, Danville had a chance, almost a 2-on-none. And the only man to save himself was the goaltender, and he did a good job. And there was another big opportunity, and it came up strong.
And we've seen a couple of those so far tonight on breakaways where we've just seen. I have no idea what that one was about. Something about number 44. Mark Anthony Simonetta being pointed out by the referee. Not sure why. Could be positive, could be negative, could be a suggestion. But either way, 0-0 here as we end the first period of Friday Night Hockey at the David S. Palmer Arena as Danville makes their way off the ice. Dennis, do you have any early thoughts for me here with one period out of the way?
Battle of the Netminders. And that's surprising me a little here. I thought we might see a little more offense by the Dashers here back home. And, you know, if it wasn't for Jesse Gordachuk coming up big, Delaware could have had a 2 or 3 goal lead after that first period. They definitely, from about the 3-minute mark on, outplayed the Dashers the rest of the way.
Yeah, there's no doubt about that. And you said it's a little surprising, and here's why. Aaron Taylor in 29 games played so far this season in goal, 8 wins, 18 losses, and a 4.61 goals against average. That is not a great stat line there from the former Dasher, a .902 save percentage. And tonight, man, he's making us look like a fool for thinking that's any indication of his ability, isn't he?
Yeah, he's coming up strong, but I have a feeling that the Dashers will make some adjustments here. What we saw from Delaware early is they were really putting a lot of pressure on the Dashers in the defensive end. They had to back off that later in the period, but I think that coach will have a solution for how to beat that pressure in the second period. We've seen a lot of games here this year at home where that first period they kind of just trade shots and trade barbs and just kind of hang in there. Then we see the big adjustments between the first and second periods, and we see a whole different offense from the Danville Dashers. I think that's what we're going to see tonight.
Yeah, and there's a reason that we've seen a little bit of offense, and there's a reason we play the game for 3 periods. We don't just simulate it like we do maybe in a video game, right? Because those outcomes may be predictable. Here, not at all, not in the Federal Prospects Hockey League, and that's why you tune in for it. Shots on the night at 11 apiece. Both sides 11 shots, and maybe a little bit generous with some of the shots, classifying them as shots on goal, because a lot of errant shots so far tonight, and maybe just getting the new ice under their feet and figuring some things out. And both sides looking to come out with a vengeance here as we head into the second period at the David S. Palmer Arena. Dennis, while we're sitting here and while we're standing here talking, if you had to pick one Dasher to break the score, and I think I know the answer to this, who are you going with? Who's your man?
You know, after that first period, I usually would take the chalk pick and take Fred Hine, but I'm going to surprise you because I really like the way Justin Brazen was finding himself in some space and getting some good shots on goal in that first period. So I'm going to give Brazen a chance to break the ice here on the scoreboard in the second period first.
That seems like a good pick. I'm going to go Chuck. I'm going to say Fred Hine breaks the scoring drought here as we head into the second period. Nonetheless, we'll be back with you in just a little bit here with a preview of the second period and a review of that first period. That was actually pretty quick, pretty quiet, pretty clean. We'll see if that continues into the second in just a little bit here on the Danville Dashers Broadcast Network. Thanks for tuning in. Welcome back here to the David S. Palmer Arena. Nate Williamson here with you for the second period of Federal Prospects Hockey League action here with my cohort, Mr. Dennis Michelson. Now, D-Mike, we're headed right into the second period. We're tied at 0-0. There's a lot of zeros on the board. There's almost zero penalties on the night. Surely things are going to get crazy in the second period, and we're going to see 7 goals by the end of this game and 800 penalties.
Just when you think you've got it figured out, I think you're going to see things get a little bit crazy. And I think during the intermission, they figured the scoreboard issue out. So I think we'll actually get to see how much time is left on the penalties when there are penalties called. But a very weird first period of hockey here at the David S. Palmer Arena, because we saw both teams trading a lot of hits but not a lot of shots. And I think we're going to see a little more aggressive offense from the Dashers in the second period. Big chance for Jesse Gordichuk to actually be one of the top stars of the game, though, based on that first period performance. He was just superb, as we've become accustomed to.
Yeah, no doubt about that. 11 shots on goal for both sides here so far tonight, and a pretty normal night, I would say. It's been pretty calm, not a lot of fighting, a little bit of uneasy, I would say, roughing going on towards the end, some big hits being thrown back and forth, but that's hockey. There's nothing unusual about that. So a pretty calm night and for FPHL standards, and as we know from the last couple of weeks, you get some interesting things that go on. Hopefully, we'll have the scoreboard running and we'll be ready here for the regular action in the second period. Just want to remind you, coming up a week from today, we talked a little bit about it earlier, February 7th, get your cowboy hats and boots out. It's going to be a lot of fun. It's country night here at the David S. Palmer Arena. That's going to be a lot of fun. It's sponsored by the Vermilion County Fair, a.k.a. the Vermilion County Farm Bureau and B&J Music. The first 300 fans are going to get an orange bandana. I don't know what the bandanas look like yet. Maybe we'll know by tomorrow. I assume we will. And I want one. I already want one. I don't know what they look like.
I need a bandana. Gotta hold back all his hair, you know?
Oh, yeah, without a doubt. I need a haircut. I think you do, too, as well I'm thinking about it. Anyway, we're going on here into the second period. A lot going on, I would say, tonight in the world of sports, and second to none here. The Danville Dashers taking on the Delaware Thunder in Federal Prospects Hockey League action. And Danville facing a tough task tonight as they were looking at a pretty strong Delaware Thunder team, especially considering they're on a 5-game losing streak. They don't look like a 5-game losing streak team. They maybe look like a 5-loss team here tonight, but stringing together their passes nicely, holding possession, doing a good job so far this evening. And right here in Danville, a long road trip for Delaware, and Danville gonna hope to jump out into the lead here in the second period.
Be interesting to see. We saw a little mix and match on that first line at the end of the first period, and we're going to see Zylak out there with Hine and Quintos, I think, to start the second period here.
Looks like it here, as we also see Municiello out there, Evgeny Demin, as well as number 32, Charlie Penns Jr., the captain for Delaware. Also out there, Daniel DeCristofaro, and on the right wing, Mark Anthony Simonetta.
A couple of happy kids here in the crowd getting hockey sticks, getting goalie sticks from Harley White during the end of the intermission here.
Huh. Nice guy, that Harley White. Now, Dennis, if you're jealous, don't worry. We have a couple back in the office. We'll get you one. Right off the bat here, Delaware on the attack. The shot from Evgeny Demin swallowed up there into the glove of Jesse Gordichuk. Pretty easy line drive shot, chest level on the left side. Not really going to test a whole lot of left-handed goalies.
Interesting thing here in the second period will be to see how the shift changes factor into things.
There was a hard shot from the left point from Delaware. Probably should have been a pass, but turned over here dangerously. Municiello has it as he's looking for an opportunity. Open ice on the goal, swallowed up off the chest of Jesse Gordichuk. Trying to get rid of the puck there was Ensor. His pass goes off the boards right back to Municiello, and now he turns the next pass over. He carries that one over. That's going to be offside, and by a long shot there, as down the left wing, nothing Logan Hawgood could do to get back on side for that one.
He was basically at the faceoff circle when that puck came in over the blue line. That was one of those whoops.
Yeah, no doubt about that. He was on a nice long vacation there down into the offensive zone. Atkins taking the faceoff here against Evgeny Demin. It's won by Atkins and pushed back to the left defense for Danville. A long shot fired onto Aaron Taylor, who sticks his stick out and redirects it away from goal. Atkins trying to grab it here along the boards, but it's broken away by Delaware. As Delaware playing down the right-hand side here and trying to break it up is Murray. Delaware with it now, two-on-one opportunity. Oh, a pass comes through the blue zone and right out of range of Jesse Gordichuk from his behind. Now coming the other way down the right wing is Danville. Jesse Nayer on it now. Nayer throws it along the boards, and he takes a hard hit. He's right back up, though, and looking to grab this one off the boards as it's pushed against the bottom of the board here. Delaware looking to come out with this one. Taylor Cutting trying to get on it. Does. He passes it back here. It's going over to number 55, Kieran Devine. Devine passes it out to Cutting. Cutting to the right-hand side to Masters. Masters coming down the right wing here. He's got McIntosh with him. Masters holds on. Oh, a nice pass to McIntosh. It's broken up, though, by Hawgood. This one fired out to the left side of Gordichuk, and body's hitting the floor like a 2000s pop song here. It's picked up eventually by Jordan Clark. No icing on this one. Is Danville going to be the first one to it here? Murray tries to pass it along. Does. Now coming the other way with it, Tesserero. It's a one-on-two with a man behind him. He's got a man to his left. Tesserero holds on to it. A nice redirected pass there is off the stick and the blocker of Aaron Taylor and out of play.
Very sloppy play here by the Dashers to open up the second period. Gave away a couple of good opportunities, but made some good recoveries to keep Delaware off the board.
Faceoff here to the right of Aaron Taylor. As sent off of it there was number 59, Brian Dunford, and in stepping is Ryan Kerr. It's lost by Delaware, but ends up in Delaware's hand. A nice hand. Oh, that was offside, but it looked to be kept on there by the left glove of number 9, Brett Menton, but he laughs that one off along with the referee. Hey, gotta plead your case, I guess. It never works, but you might as well do it.
Yeah, he was onside, but the puck was offside, and he had a pretty quick glove to try to get away with that one, but the official
right on
the
top
play.
Of it. Yeah, just like normal. Tesserero harks this one down into the right-hand corner. It comes all the way out to point man Brad Denny off the stick of Aaron Taylor. That one passed through a forest of bodies on its way to Taylor. A nice hustle play there to keep it in. That was Murray. Murray fires a hard shot to the left of Aaron Taylor. Delaware on it now, coming the other way through Ryan Kerr. Kerr tries an outlet pass. It's going to come all the way around to Gordichuk, who's out of his net to play it. Kerr harking. He's almost got it on there. Instead, on the other end of that was number 86, Brennan Young, who was lurking. Gordichuk does just enough to get it out of the way. A hard hit there laid by number 28, Thomas Municello, as Danville come the other way down the left wing. Got the body, did not get the puck there. As Patrick Zalak was threatening, instead it's turned over here to Municello, and he plays it past a man on the left side. Got past Fred Hine, not an easy feat, and he's going to have to get past a few more for an open shot on goal. He does, a backhanded shot there, saved by the chest of Jesse Gordichuk as Danville trying to get this one out of their zone. They're going to try to do it through Fred Hine, who fires a pass off of a Delaware offensive player, and thus no icing as it's played there by Aaron Taylor. And this one, just a group of long passes. Gordichuk, the first one to it, cutting there, blows a skate down in the side. Oh, and a redirected pass there off of DeCristofaro, finds Fred Hine. Oh, off the center there, and that one is broken up nicely by DeCristofaro, who makes up for his mistake. Coming to the right here now is Ryan Kerr down the right-hand side. Actually, that was shot on there by number 44, Mark Anthony Simonetta. Cutting on it now to Simonetta. Simonetta on the side here on the boards, being pressured by Sam Turner. Simonetta holds on to it, even hitting the glass, still brings it back. A shot from the point. That one was actually stopped there by McIntosh before it even got to Jesse Gordichuk and popped up into the air.
Trying for the redirect, but got too much of it with the back of the stick.
Ended up with a save, right?
Yeah.
Now the other way, it's in the Danville defensive zone as Delaware pressing. Danville going to have a chance to run with it down the right-hand side here. Coming the other way, Jesse Nayer. A nice stick deep pass one. A backhanded wrister goes over the head of Aaron Taylor and comes along the boards and comes as far as number 23, Eric Masters, who plays it on. Just doing enough to get Kieran Devine off of it was Murray, and he's being cross-checked along the boards there. No harm, no foul, according to the referee. Is this one thrown down? He had his hand in the air for icing. It's waved off, though, as Mitch Atkins ends up with it in the end. Must have been touched up, and I must have missed that one. Now coming the other way with it, Nair. Nair across the point here, Murray. Murray's going to have some space. Murray has a shot. It bounces off the right side of Taylor, trying to shove it in there. Was Danville. A backhanded shot is wide there from Jesse Nair. It comes all the way back out to Murray, who tries to throw it through. Instead, it's stopped up by Delaware. Jesse Nair back on it now. Nair, like a guided heat-seeking missile, grabbing this puck in multiple occasions here. And it's pressed up against the boards here for his trouble. Trying to get it there. McIntosh is in there. You can also see Kieran Devine in there. For Danville, it's Nair. It's also Brousen. This one on the stick of McIntosh, held across the boards in his defensive zone. It comes out to Brousen, who wraps around. No goal. That one got blocked off by Taylor. Everyone in the arena thought he had it on that one. And everybody in the arena about to get a puck as a souvenir as that one flipped out of play.
And a little bit of pushing and shoving right along the Dashers bench here.
On the other end of it is Evgeny Demin, who was there trying to do a little bit of talking with Troy Murray. Justin Brousen sees that one out. As hustled back to the benches, the two respective teams getting in there, Anthony Pisano. And we're going to see who comes out for both sides here, as it looks like we're going to get some pretty big line changes.
Referee's doing a really good job of letting the guys jaw a little bit, get some of that frustration out. But once they had had enough, they got very active in making sure both teams separated. Good job by the refs.
And Jacob Kohlmeyer was in there on that, and a little bit short in stature, maybe especially compared to number 33, Anthony Pisano. Nonetheless, he's got the power, and he pushes him back into the Delaware bench. And that's a testament to referees, I would say. They're not afraid, even when shorter in stature than a majority of these guys. Delaware with a nice passing effort coming down right off the right shoulder pad of Jesse Gordichuk. That was a nice opportunity for Delaware. And it came through the stick of Ryan Kerr, who created the opportunity. Coming the other way with it, Danville throws this one down into the right corner. Gullo on it. Instead, it comes all the way out to DeCristofaro, who pushes it up the ice. It gets as far as 86, Brendan Young, before it's turned over to Danville. Taking a hard hit there was Troy Murray. Actually, Levi Armstrong, and then he's fighting for it back as he pushes this one down. Brad Denny blows a skate. This one's coming down the right-hand side. It's a race between Brett Menton and number 86, Brendan Young, for it. Menton wins out. That one off the skate here. Dangerous for Delaware. Opportunity here. And they're on the right side pushing it in. Gordichuk going to have to wrap up here as we have a delayed penalty actually in favor of Danville as they're coming down the right-hand side here of the ice. And this one going to be a penalty here. Looks like it's going to be a high stick. A few groans from the Delaware bench. And Taylor cutting a little frustrated by it. We don't quite see who it's on just yet. Looks like it's going to be on Thomas Municiello.
Yep.
And Charlie Penn's not happy about it.
Yeah, he was very active with the stick right in front of Gordichuk and actually got a little piece of Gordichuk's mask, I think. And I think that's what got the call.
And Jacob Kohlmeyer escorts him over to the penalty box, and we are on a Jennaworth power play here in Danville.
Dashers doing a really good job of finding the open space here at full strength here in the second period, so I think we're going to see him cash in this time.
In a moment like this, you can almost feel the atmosphere rising inside of an arena like the David S. Palmer Arena as fans kind of start to shake off the rust, get a little bit back into it here as they look for a scoring opportunity.
Hey, even the fans have gotten out of practice around here. Been on the road for a while, Nate.
That's a long road trip, let me tell you.
We just need more cowbell. That'll get the guys going.
More cowbell is always the solution as Sam Turner comes down the left-hand side. He's pressed off there by Masters. Masters tries to get it with a skate. A good hustle play, just a little bit too short on the leg to get it. Turner on in front of net here. He redirect, bounces dangerously in front of Aaron Taylor. Off the stick of Jesse Nair, a good opportunity there for Danville with 1:37 left to go in the power play. A 13:23 left to go in the penalty or in the second period here. Delaware penalty kill up to full scratch here as that one's thrown all the way behind the goal of Jesse Gordichuk.
Did a good job of fixing that scoreboard during the intermission.
They did. It comes in handy, doesn't it? Jesse Nair coming down the right wing here. He's got a little bit of space. Instead, Alexa Fred Hine, who throws it across the ice over there to number 26, Logan Hoggood.
Fires from the point.
Oh, a shot on the chest of Aaron Taylor off the redirect. A.J. Tesorero trying to be a puck hawk there. Instead, it's swallowed up by Aaron Taylor with 1:08 left to go here in the power play. 12:58 left to go here in the second period.
Justin Brazen was just there again, ready to hawk for that rebound, but that puck, just Taylor hanging on to it wisely.
And when you have a line with Tesserero and Brazen out there, you really like to see shots from distance because they can redirect, they can poke it out, they can put back in the rebound. They have a lot of experience and a lot of ability with the stick.
Great move by Simonetta there, just kind of taking extra time off of the penalty kill.
Mitch Atkins down the right-hand side, a little bit of a move there, backhand. Oh, it was swallowed up nicely by Taylor. What a move, Mitch Atkins, just a puck drag. Looked like a shootout goal, looked like a sure goal at that. Instead, sorted out by Taylor as McIntosh drops it down the aisle behind the net of Jesse Gordichuk.
30 seconds left in the power play.
Danville looking to build something here. Not a whole lot of offensive momentum moving forward, but instead it comes down the left-hand wing here as it comes back out to the point to Murray. Murray over to Ensor. Ensor tries to find a pass. It's sticked up there by DeCristofaro. On the left-hand side here for Barakov. Barakov ends up finding the stick of number 8, Mitch Atkins.
You see a little more movement here on the power play.
Atkins to Murray, redirected, attempted there by Barakov. Instead, it's going to be sent down the ice, and that's going to do it for the Jenneworth power play here with 11:44 left to go. We're still deadlocked at 2-2. A shot there off the stick of number 59, Brian Dunford, is swallowed up by Gordichuk. Man, what a momentum killer that would have done if Brian Dunford had been able to place that shot. Instead, it's Gordichuk getting the upper hand, and we remain scoreless here on Friday night action in Danville.
Another dangerous turnover by the Dashers, and another opportunity thwarted by Jesse Gordichuk. That might be my word for the second period. Thwarted.
Thwarted. Need a thesaurus, Dennis. We're going to have to buy you one. This one trapped up along the boards. Probably the third or fourth time we've seen that so far tonight, as this one is pressed in and eventually going to come up with it. It looks like Bryce Litke had a stick on it, but it goes right back into the boards nonetheless. Tesserero proves to be the stronger man in that situation at least, as Armstrong almost comes up lucky with an instant of fortune there. Let's say that. Nick Gullo ends up with it. Passes it back to Brett Menton. Touched up nicely there. A good hustle play, Levi Armstrong. As Tesserero on it now, tries to throw it through to Nick Gullo. Instead, it's sticked away harmlessly by Aaron Taylor. Gullo on it now behind the left side of the goal of Aaron Taylor as he's fighting for it with number 15, Bryce Litke. It's eventually pushed out. It's going to be a foot race here to get to this one. It's going to be run by Brett Menton. A dangerous pass there, though, comes out to Munichello, fresh out of the penalty box. Munichello fires a shot. It didn't get as far as Brad Denny before it was stopped up by a leg. And Danville able to recover here only momentarily, though. Delaware actually pushing four men up into the offensive zone, trying to get that puck back. Armstrong tries to redirect that one. It comes out over the glass in another souvenir, much like the first one that went out of the glass, pretty much the same spot. I wonder if the same person got it.
Every time that Menton is on the ice for the Dashers on the defensive pairing, that's when Delaware is really pushing guys forward on the pressure.
Maybe trying to get ahead of that chemistry building with Menton and his newly acquired teammates as he joins the Danville Dashers squad at past the midpoint of the season. As this one's fought for in the open ice of between the blue lines, it ends up in the stick of Sam Turner. Turner with a stick move, he gets open. 3-on-2 for Danville down the left-hand side. Turner with a nice move, tries to push it in on Aaron Taylor, who falls on it. Oh, it was in and out of the glove, but blown dead nonetheless here as looming was Patrick Zalak.
Good opportunity for the Dashers. They really put the numbers forward and got a good effort there. But Taylor, once again, coming up strong between the pipes.
Now coming the other way with it here as we have a face-off to the right side of Aaron Taylor as both are sent off. One for the money, two for the show. New guys in the circle, and here we go as Fred Hines steps in as well as Thomas Munichello. This one won by Delaware, played back behind here by number 92, Daniel DeCristofaro. And trying to hook up there with Evgeny Demin. Instead, off the stick of Demin, he gets it back though and passes it to Munichello. Pressed along the boards but keeps control of the puck. It ends up with Simonetta. Simonetta on it again here, wrapping around the goal of Jesse Gordichuk. Simonetta with a nice stick move to get the Dashers going the other way. But up to the task is the Dasher defense. Instead, it's going to end up in the stick of Evgeny Demin. Has a little bit of sloppy play here in front of the boards from both sides. Nobody really able to get it. Instead, we're going to come the other way. Fred Hine fires a shot, and it's swallowed up by Aaron Taylor. Not exactly a challenging shot, but a shot nonetheless, as we're getting a shoving match here on the right-hand side of the ice. And I can see this one turn it into a fight very quickly. It's Patrick Zalat going up against Evgeny Demin here as they're separated nicely by the officials. And we're going to have our media timeout, 9:27 left to go here in the second period. You know, it hasn't exactly been a boring game, but it has been a little devoid of the type of action we're used to seeing in terms of offense and in terms of maybe aggression, maybe a little bit of physicality. Although, like I said, it hasn't been devoid of that necessarily, just maybe a little bit less.
Dasher's given up a lot of easy chances to Delaware, but Delaware hasn't been able to take advantage of it yet. And on the other side of the offensive end, when the Dashers have had the rare opportunity that they get some numbers, they just have not been able to finish off the play. A lot of it is a little bit of sloppiness on the offensive end from both teams, but got to give credit where credit's due to both netminders being able to thwart the opposition and keep them off the scoreboard.
Shot totals now 21-18 in favor of the Danville Dashers as we're a little bit past the midpoint of the second period. Only two penalties assessed on the night, both on Delaware, the most recent going against Thomas Municello about 6 or 7 minutes ago here for a high sticking call. Still 0-0 blanked out on the scoreboard, not a technical difficulty, just 0-0. A little bit of devoid of scoring, but not devoid of some solid work from these goaltenders here as we line up in front of Aaron Taylor's goal. Stick tied here, and it ends up in the stick of Danville. Jesse Nayer had it. Taylor Cutting lost his stick there on the left side of the action. Instead, it's Atkins pushed along the boards. Nice defensive effort there from Evan McIntosh.
Rousen working hard against the boards there.
Rousen trying to use his body, use his stick, just about whatever he can to get that puck. And Taylor Cutting is actually going to carry it down the right wing. He's got space, stepped up there. He's got an open net. Tries to fire it across there on the other side. Waiting was Eric Masters. How about that would have been for a homecoming from the two former Dashers? That one fired from the point from Pisano into the swallowed up black hole that is the glove of Jesse Gordichuk.
Boy, Hagen tried to make an interception of a pass at center ice there, missed and was out of position. Delaware had numbers, but once again, Gordichuk coming up strong with the save. And he was kind of off balance on that last shot. I think it caught him a little bit by surprise.
As we line up to the right here of Jesse Gordichuk, and we have a slight stoppage here. I think maybe a little discussion about the clock again. I don't know. 8:53 left to go in the second period is what we're working with for now. A quick explanation to the captain, Charlie Penns, and we're back and ready to go. As this one won by Delaware, dangerous opportunity here in front of the net. Instead, it's sorted out by Barakov. He's got Armstrong coming down the other way with it. Armstrong with a nice fake there is going to put Tesserero on. It's high of Aaron Taylor. Flying in from behind there, Brett Menton with a nice hit to get the puck back at least momentarily. Oh, almost kept in there as well by Armstrong. Instead, shot up and almost out of play, just a little bit short of going over the glass. Instead, we're going to see this one come down. And it's going to be played by Levi Armstrong into the side corner here. Played behind by DeCristofaro. He's going to take it up the left-hand side. Passed out there to number two, Ryan Kerr. Kerr from the left-hand side, a shot sticked up by Jesse Gordichuk. That one was hanging dangerously in the balance there.
Boy, that puck was just a matter of inches of finding a Delaware stick at the wrong place at the wrong time.
Nicely touched up there by Brennan Young as he's coming down the right-hand side. He's got Municello. Municello, open ice, save Jesse Gordichuk. What a beaut.
Wow, that pass had Gordichuk fooled right on the stick of the Delaware player. But Gordichuk sprawling out as he went from side to side to make an impressive stop. Another impressive stop for Gordy.
We little excitement, I suppose, there in front of the Delaware bench is, who knows? That's all I can say about that. Now in the faceoff circle, Evgeny Demin here. Fred Hine wins it out. It comes back behind the net of the Danville Dashers as they're coming the other way with it. Delaware with it now on the other side here. Out to the point, kept in nicely there by Delaware. A shot to the left-hand side of Gordachuk is gloved up and carried away. That one came off the stick of number 15, Bryce Littke.
Like everybody else in the place.
Wasn't really sure what happened there in front of the Delaware bench, but a beer was involved.
Always promising. This faceoff won by Danville, actually, after taking it back from Delaware's Fred Hine with a shot. Oh, a beauty save there by Aaron Taylor off a left-handed shot from Fred Hine. He was aiming bar down on Taylor's left side. Taylor gloves it like a Derek Jeter at shortstop.
Now, I think Taylor was expecting the possibility of a pass, but boy, oh boy, Fred Hine with a lightning shot, but once again, Taylor comes up strong.
Danville winning their fair share of faceoffs here. A shot swallowed up once again by Taylor off the stick of Fred Hine.
Good pad save that time.
And he locked that one up as easy as you'd like from a veteran goaltender now, as weird as it is to say. He was a rookie last year. This one won by Danville. It's coming across to Ensor here. Ensor with a nice pass. It finds a shot from the right-hand side. Just goes wide right of Aaron Taylor as Quintos was on the stick for that one. Some nice movement here by Danville as this one comes out to the point way high there of Aaron Taylor, but it bounces off in an opportune spot for Fred Hine to get it. It's tangled up behind the net, and it's out, and it's in front of net. It actually bounced over the net here.
Oh.
And Delaware going to have an open shot here. Now going is Evgeny Demin. Demin one-on-one from the right side. Couldn't keep the puck. Jesse Gordachuk doing just enough. And almost a rebound opportunity there coming the other way as Danville going to try and get this one out of their zone. They get it out, but it's shot by right back down all the way to Gordachuk here. As Delaware really pushing men forward now. Municello playing pressure here as this one is passed around between the Danville defensemen. And a long stretch pass there to Zalak is nicely played with a foot. Fred Hine on it now with a little bit of space. Off the leg of Delaware's number 33, Anthony Pisano. Tried to find right in the right-hand slot there, trying to maybe shove it under the armpit of Aaron Taylor. But instead, it's saved by Taylor. In on that was Patrick Zalak and a mixture of Fred Hine and number 10, Tyler Quintos.
If you would have bet me that it would be scoreless with 6:35 left in the second, I wouldn't have taken that. I would have taken that bet because I was for certain that we'd see three or four goals by now.
On other nights, you would think easy money, but apparently not tonight as Aaron Taylor, Jesse Gordachuk doing a great job at the opportunities, which have honestly been a little bit more limited than we're used to.
Nice poke.
Browsing with a nice stick move. He gets through, and it's out into the left wing. Sputters out between the defense to Mitch Atkins. Atkins trying to find Browsing, but he's thrown into the boards before he can do so. Instead, Alexi used the foot and pass it out to Browsing, who has it on the right-hand side. Tries a wrister. Instead, it's actually swallowed up by Mitch Atkins on accident there. Has this one out in a hurry to the crowd. And looks like everybody's okay. So winner, winner, chicken dinner there as somebody gets a souvenir on a rebounded backward shot, I would say.
Good glove save without the glove in the stands, and we're going to see a penalty to boot.
Municello finds his way to the penalty box here. With about 6:07 left to go in the second period, we're going to have a Jenna Worth power play. Danville surely going to capitalize on this, their third.
I didn't see what that one was all about.
I think that puck may have been a clearance right out of the ice, actually, and that's why it came out so fast.
Little dog penalty, maybe.
Can only imagine. Sam Turner on the right defenseman slot here. He fires a long point shot. It's blockered off right there by Charlie Penns as he gets ahead of it before Aaron Taylor even has to do so. Tesserero behind the net now out to the point. On to now Hoggood. Hoggood's got Brazen to his left and Seds goes to his left instead to Tesserero. Brazen was on his right. This one back out to Turner. Turner on it now fires a shot. It's right blockered away by Taylor. On to now Tesserero. Tesserero back to Brazen. Brazen with a nice opportunity, a nice man-made opportunity there into the leg of Thomas Municello as he hits the deck. That one definitely didn't feel good. Oh. But on the other end, it's Demin who's going to have an opportunity. Demin gets past one. He fires it back to Municello. Municello is shot wide left to Gordachuk. And Justin Brazen, that one ended as quickly as it started there for Delaware with 1:08 left to go on the Jenna Worth power play. As behind the net here is Sam Turner.
Always dangerous when you're on a power play, when you give up a clearing move there and They can get the player deep. Almost a shorthander there.
Yeah, it almost seemed as though it would be. The last time we were here, we saw two shorthanded goals by Danville, actually, in that weekend stand. Maybe Delaware trying to replicate the feat here as this one comes back to Troy Murray. Murray and Enser out there to the defensive pairing. It comes out to Barakov, who's got some space. Barakov with a shot. It's blocked up there by the captain, Charlie Penns Jr., and sent firmly down the ice by Evan McIntosh. As this one gets all the way to Gordichuk with 28 seconds left to go in the Genoworth power play. 4:33 left to go in the second period.
Delaware putting a lot of bodies in front of that net. Hard to get them through.
And so we're playing it back to Murray here. Murray carries across the blue line. He's got a little bit of space here. He's swallowed up there. On a defensive shift was Kieran Devine. Back to Ensor to Murray. Accidentally there over to Mitch Atkins. Actually, Tyler Quintos. Quintos back to Ensor. Fires a shot. It's high of Aaron Taylor as he braces. A little bit wide, though, too, as well.
Back to full strength.
Shot from the point here as the penalty expires. Almost a rebound opportunity off the boards there. Couldn't have scripted that one better. As we're back to full strength here at the David S. Palmer Arena. Delaware working it down the right-hand side here through number 44, Simonetta. Litke going to have an opportunity here. He found a nice pass there. Should have found the stick of Simonetta, who had an open net instead. Danville going to bring it the other way now. Come the other way with it is Turner. There are Mitch Atkins.
Mitch Atkins taking on the entire team there on that drive.
A hard slap shot comes all the way back around the ice and finds Brad Denny, who finds Quintos. He's looking for a cutter, but nobody there, as that one comes all the way back to Brett Menton. Now coming the other way, Brad Denny going to just outrace there for number 86, was hunting down. That was Brendan Young, who could have had an icing there, but instead just beats it out. We do have an icing.
I think they're calling that play dead on a stick above the weights.
Oh, a high stick there. Yeah. Okay. Thought it came all the way back around, but never perfect. Come the other way with it is Danville trying to work something out of their offensive zone. Delaware pushing three up and two on this left-hand side here, trying to get anything back. Some nice puck combination here finds Gullo. Gullo tries to make a move, a nice stick there by Charlie Penn, sees it away though. Now coming the other way with it, Brian Dunford. Dunford with a slapper that goes off the leg of Brett Menton. Menton on Dunford. As this one comes all the way out to DeCristofaro. DeCristofaro, a shot into traffic.
Oh, look out.
This one's already been waved off, no goal. And it's been waved off and is now behind the net as Gordichuk's on the ground without a helmet. And he has no idea where the puck is, just elects to sprawl out, and it's all the way out at the blue line.
It almost looked like a stick from the Delaware Thunder got tangled up with the skates of Jesse Gordichuk, not letting him get back to his feet.
As we got a little huddle in front of the ice as Gordichuk recollects himself. On the replay, it does look like Gordichuk might have been tripped up there a little bit. Not a whole lot in that as he just struggled to find his skate when he tried to get back up here and elected to go back down, and play stops when a goalie doesn't have a helmet naturally, but man, a dangerous situation there for the Dashers defense with 2:41 left to go here in the second frame of action.
Woo! Yeah, I don't think there was any penalty there that should have been called. It was just they got tied up with all of the sticks that were laying in front of the goal. There was a lot of traffic out there.
And that first shot right into traffic, and Cutting fires another one that goes actually off the leg there of Justin Brousen. Comes all the way back around to Sam Turner. As this one comes down the right-hand wing with Danville, Mitch Atkins had it, stumbles, gets it back. As this one in the offensive zone for Danville, now on it is Nayer. Nayer with an open shot on the right-hand side. Atkins unable to swallow it up. It comes back out for the rebound, but right there to stop Brousen from capitalizing was Evan McIntosh, who shoves him away just in the nick of time as Aaron Taylor had that one bounce off of his chest pad.
Yeah, McIntosh did a great job of lifting the stick of the Dashers player, preventing the rebound chance there. Nice play by Delaware.
Face off to the right of Aaron Taylor here. Trying to shoot off the point there was Justin Brousen. Instead, it comes all the way back here to number 55, Kieran Devine. Now come the other way with it, number 3, Evan McIntosh, who fires a shot off the left blocker there of Jesse Gordichuk as he slides over to make the save. Danville going to look to come the other way. Ensor had it, lays it off to Nayer.
Got numbers.
Nayer finds a man on the left-hand side. It's Atkins. Atkins tries to find open space there. Almost had Nayer, but it was nicely cut off there by Anthony Pisano. And going to have a run for it is Masters. Masters is going to be the first one to this as he's able to get around the boards, play it out into space. Dangerous. Oh, a nice sliding save there by Fred Hine. And talk about a defensive effort as he's got it now going on the attack. He might have a one-on-one if he's fast. Coming down the left-hand side, a shot off of the chest of Aaron Taylor. Rebound is high.
Oh.
Patrick Zalak probably could have done better with that one, but a dangerous situation there as Fred Hine, Mr. Hustle on both sides of the ice. Sheer back and forth action here with 1:30 left to go in the second period.
Fred, obviously the reputation of being the great goal scorer, but he's such an all-around player, making the big defensive stop, and then the outlet pass, then the great shot, and Zylak had the net open but missed.
How good a shot from the point goes off the leg there of Municello. As this one won by Delaware, 1:18 left to go here in the second period. Danville gets it back. Fred Hine on it, tries to find a space. He does eventually, but it's broken up there by the stick of Bryce Littke. This one comes back around to Fred Hine. Hine plays it along the glass here to Patrick Zalak. Zalak on it, he stumbles. And this one comes back to Delaware. Delaware gonna have a 3-on-3 if they move quickly here. Trying to feed it around the circle, comes out to Municello. Municello lays it off there to Simonetta. Simonetta with a shot that doesn't get as far as Jesse Gordichuk. Logan Hoggood was in on the block.
Oh. Dangerous play again.
Fred Hine gets to it first, does just enough. This one might be dangerous. Danville couldn't get to the puck fast enough, though, as it comes all the way back to the captain, Charlie Penns. This one might be an icing. It's going to be a race here to see who gets to it first. It was waved off. Danville on the right-hand side here, 34 seconds left to go in the second period, and this one shot all the way down from beyond the blue zone back down to Jesse Gordichuk, as behind the net recollecting is Logan Hoggood. Hoggood throws it out to the left-hand side. Stretch pass is chipped up there, and a heads-up play by Masters as he's going to actually end up with this one down the left wing after blocking that pass. Tries to find something in space instead. It was dealt with by Danville. It just ekes out, and Masters with a hustle play able to get back on it. A shot from the point. There is a goal.
Oh, man.
What a shot from Charlie Penns in his home return here. Coming back to his team from last season as Charlie Penns breaks the deadlock with 6.3 left to go in the second period. Delaware takes a 1-0 lead.
And he was the player that was getting sort of the business from a Dashers fan. Nothing sweeter to get the revenge than to get the first goal of the night, putting a big shot past Gordichuk, who didn't have a chance on that one.
How about the celly, too? A nice celebration there from Charlie Penns. And when he scores, you're going to know it. As this faceoff is won by Delaware, comes out to Penns, who throws it down, and that should just about do it here as time runs out in the second period.
Sloppy play by Danville. Delaware able to cash in.
I gotta say, a non-redirected shot from the point from Charlie Penns Jr. is not how I saw that deadlock being broken here on Friday night at the David S. Palmer Arena. Nonetheless, Delaware with a shot with just 6 seconds left is gonna take a one-goal lead here into the second period, and not a period of chaos, not a period of a lot of boring action, and because of it, we got a goal at the end of it. You got to take your opportunities when you got them, and that's what Charlie Penns just did. And he's going to walk off happy, smiling into that locker room. A big momentum play for Delaware. We're trying to snap this losing streak with everything they can do here in Danville tonight.
Boy, it just looks like the Danville Dashers team is just a little off their game tonight, being really sloppy, giving a lot of chances to Delaware up until that last 6 seconds of the second period. They got away with it because Gordichuk has been so strong in the net, but there, as time was running out, you could just see that the Dashers are trying to hang on to finish off that second period. But what a rocket of a shot from Penns. And 1-0 Delaware after two.
And as such, we're going to get Chuck-a-puck action here at the David S. Palmer Arena. We'll be back in about 15 minutes here as we start the third period. It's sure to be a hotly contested and a very good game here coming down the stretch, especially now that we've seen our first goal. We're hoping that kind of takes the lid, per se, or maybe the wall out in front of this game as a whole, because not a whole lot of scoring action, not a whole lot of chances converted. We have seen a lot of chances, and as such, we've got quite a few shots on goal here tonight. 29 shots for Danville, 28 for Delaware. We ended the first period tied at shots, and we ended the second period with just one shot splitting the difference here. 17 shots on goal in this period for Delaware and 18 for Danville. And it's Charlie Penns coming back to his team from last season and splitting the difference here with a shot from the point that beat Jesse Gordichuk. Was a nicely taken opportunity. Maybe not how you see this goal drought being broken here, but Delaware currently on course to snap their losing streak here at the David S. Palmer Arena. We'll be back in just a little bit for more of the third period here as we start the homestand here for Danville. Going to be very interesting down the stretch. You're going to want to be here. We'll be back in just a few minutes talking about some scores from around the league as well as some NHL action on the evening. Welcome back here to the David S. Palmer Arena. Getting ready for the third period of action here as the Danville Dashers trail by one goal to the Delaware Thunder, who've come into town with a bang, per se, I would say, with Charlie Penns Jr. from the point being the only goal so far in this game tonight. We also have four other final scores for the evening, not something we would have said a whole lot last season, as we do have a lot more expansion teams in the game now, which is amazing. We hope for more to come. In Danbury, at the Danbury Ice Arena, the Hat Tricks took on the Carolina Thunderbirds and took down the league-leading Carolina Thunderbirds by a score of 3-2.
Wow.
Danbury seemingly to have the kryptonite to what has been the Carolina Thunderbirds, and man, every game between them has at least been a fight. Danbury, I think, has handed every loss to Carolina so far this season, if I remember correctly. I'd have to do some fact-checking on that.
I think you are correct, Nate.
It was a contested game. Matias Kasich opened the scoring. Danbury actually scored three in a row, and we're up 3-0 on Carolina. And the final goal came from Casper Dearson, as the next two goals were in the second period. A shorthander from Carolina as Connor Haas scored, and Daniel Klinecki scored the last goal, although they did fall short, and Danbury gets a home win against Carolina by a 3-2 score. Another game going on tonight, Elmira taking on the River Dragons at home. Elmira won that one by a score of 4-1 as well. Not as much of a contested game, and a result that you would have more expected, I would say, as Tyler Urich scored in one of his early games here as an Elmira enforcer, and he scored twice. That trade will pay off dividends, I can already tell you, for the Elmira enforcers as they score 4 to the River Dragons 1. Another game going on tonight over in Port Huron, as Port Huron beat the Menor Icebreakers by a score of 4-2. Mike Moroso had 3 points all night, including two goals to lead Port Huron to the victory at home. The final game here will cover Watertown, a 4-1 win over the Battle Creek Rumblebees. The first star, Derek Boudreau, had 3 points, and that was a hat trick. Michael Desjardins had 3 points on 3 assists, and the lone goal for Battle Creek coming from former Dasher Nathan Poligra. So a 4-1 score there in Watertown. So the big story on the night, Danbury taking down the league-leading Carolina Hat Tricks, taking down the league-leading Carolina Thunderbirds. Wild. Just a wild night around the league, and we get to see it all again tomorrow with every team in the league in action. Once again, it'll be Carolina traveling to Danbury, River Dragons from Columbus traveling to Elmira, and the Battle Creek Rumblebees traveling to Watertown, while the Menor Icebreakers go to Port Huron. Those games, the one in Danbury, set to tip off at 6 o'clock Central. 6:05 Central, or 7:05 Eastern, is the game in Elmira, and Watertown at 6:30 Central, 7:30 Eastern, and Port Huron also at 6:30 Central, 7:30 Eastern. As for us tomorrow, we'll be here at 7:05 Central, 8:05 Eastern. Make sure to tune in. It's going to be a lot of fun here, judging by the first two periods of this game. As we have about a minute and a half here until we get ready to go back into the action, do want to tell you a little bit about our sponsors and some of the nights that we have coming up. As always, we talked a little bit about Country Night next week. After that, we have Reggae Wines Beach Party Night. Very, very fun last year. A lot of fun. Our shootout, actually, our intermission shootout, was with coconuts.
Wow.
I got to actually go out there after the game and shoot coconuts. You cannot do a slap shot with a coconut, Dennis, let me tell you.
I've got my Hawaiian shirt already.
I'm ready to be a tourist. I really am. I might even wear shorts. Coming up on February 8th, if you're a part of the Kids Club, you're going to have an exclusive skate after the game. Dennis, am I too old to join that?
No. I might even get my double runner skates out and join you out there.
And, of course, you have to show your Kids Club membership card to skate in that. There's also going to be a player appearance at the Catlin American Legion on Thursdays, 5 to 8 p.m., all during the month of February, every Thursday. Burger and french fries, $5. That sounds really good. I'm starving.
And I am told that the burgers are fantastic. I might have to make that trip out for that.
I believe it. Also, as every night, we chuck a puck. Make sure to get in on that tomorrow if you didn't tonight. Right now, we got some people sitting in the best seat of the house, sponsored by Court. Currently, doing a little bit of bottle flipping. So that's a little bit of fun there in the intermission. Might be the most exciting thing going on at the ice level right now. We'll see if anybody can get it. And not having a lot of luck so far. 0 for 3, 0 for 4 from both sides. Bottle flipping at the David S. Palmer Arena. Who would have thought that would be the intermission entertainment? There's one. It only took about 5 tries, and I can relate to that. It took me a long time to get that done. Well, hey, if your nonprofit organization is looking for fundraising opportunities, contact info@danvilledashers.com. Sign up to work the Chuckapuck table or fundraise by selling group tickets. Always a great time to bring some friends and family out to a David S. Palmer Arena Danville Dashers game. A lot of good stuff going up here in the months to come. We talked about Country Night, Reggae Wines Beach Party, and, of course, the official post-game party place, the Vermilion River Beer Company. Go there. Tell them the Dashers sent you over there. Just go ahead and do it. They're going to be making appearances there throughout the season. It's going to be a lot of fun. That is a nice place there and very, very close to the arena, almost within walking distance. It's pretty close.
Oh, might have to check that out, one of these games.
It's a nice area over there. Eventually, we're hoping to do a coach's show, probably heading into a playoff season, I would hope, here, as we currently are close to that.
Getting late early in the season. I can't believe we're almost into February. Turn the page into February tomorrow.
Craziness. And someone in the chat did ask who the guy who shot the puck into the bench was last week. That was Brody Duncan. He has been suspended for the rest of the season.
Yeah, pretty ugly situation. I did have a chance to ask Fred Hine about that today, get his opinion. He said from what he saw on the replay, he says there's no excuse for that.
Yeah, there's definitely no excuse for that, and it's a big statement by the FPHL also to make sure he was rewarded for his reasons justly and suspended for the rest of the season.
And I agree with Fred's call. He says suspend him for the rest of the season, but let him come back next year. I think that's the right decision, and it looks like that's what's going to be done.
Yeah, I think that's the right decision there. And, I mean, in hockey, tempers do flare. Things happen. I've seen worse checks into the boards than I probably have more dangerous shots into the bench like that. But still, nonetheless, much deserved suspension there. And we have a stoppage here, actually, before we even start the third period. We'll get a word on what exactly is going on. All players almost off the ice, except for Mitch Atkins, Aaron Taylor, and Jesse Gordachuk. And Gordachuk actually going to come over here off the ice as well. Might be waiting on word for something, maybe some scoreboard technical issues, stat-keeping issues. You never really know, and without a direct phone line down there and no assistant to run it, not really going to know. But we'll be here until they start, and it's going to be interesting to see here in the third and final frame, you would think. 1-0 score here, Delaware on top of the Danville Dashers. It's going to be a hectic period. I can feel it coming. Anytime you see guys out there kind of moving their feet around, getting ready to come out on the ice, you know they're ready and rearing to go for this third period. Delaware with a huge momentum killer for Danville at the end of that period. Just when it looked like Danville might finally score, Charlie Penz fires home from the point and beats Jesse Gordachuk, who until then had been having a great night on the evening.
I think it was just Coach Ray Tremblay wasn't done with his Domino's pizza yet.
I could use a Domino's pizza. Feel free to send one here as Danville loses out on that one, and it comes back to the left point there. On it there was Charlie Penz Jr., the goal scorer, as this one's shot all the way down the ice to Danville's Sam Turner. Turner to Brousen. Brousen plays it off the boards and high and hard, as this one's going to be picked up by Penz, blocked up by Atkins. Instead, it's going to be a delayed offside here as that one came off the foot of Brousen, and Danville elects to come back onside and restart again here as it's carried over the blue line. A pass from Penz over to Simonetta. Simonetta with a shot, and that one's gloved out nicely. What a save, Jesse Gordachuk. And it almost seems pedestrian anymore how quickly his glove moves, but let me tell you, that's a special arm talent in a whole nother way. And I'm not talking about Patrick Mahomes with the Super Bowl coming up.
He is really spoiling us here. Getting to watch him play each and every night, that kid's got a lot of talent.
No doubt, a faceoff here to the right side of the aforementioned Jesse Gordachuk. Nayer trying to fight for it there with number 23, Eric Masters. Masters wins out, fires a shot wide to the left of the glove of Jesse Gordachuk. This one picked up by Taylor Cutting. He's pressed into the boards there by Brousen. Now coming the other way with it, Sam Turner. He's got a little space. He might elect to shoot this. Instead, elects to pass it up. It's tipped up there by DeCristofaro. And now coming the other way with it is Delaware with Eric Masters. Eric Masters blows the skate here, loses it up. It comes around to Evan McIntosh as Delaware gets back onside. And Seth Ensor grabs it behind the net of Jesse Gordachuk.
Dashers starting this third period with some sloppy puck handling again.
Hine to Ensor, off the boards there to Quintos. Quintos throws it down here. No real effect on that one as Anthony Pisano throws it forward. This one's going to come all the way out to number 86, Brennan Young. Young still carrying it in. He passes it forward. Shot on to Jesse Gordichuk and swallowed up.
That one sort of got stuck in the pads. I think Gordichuk was trying to keep the puck alive because his defenseman was right there to make a nice play on the puck, but it kind of got all tangled up in the equipment.
That was Brian Dunford on the shot there. Sticked away off the faceoff by Jesse Gordichuk. As this one's brought back around here by Danville. Zalak able to get it out of the zone and try and fight for it back. It was picked up there by Kieran Devine. And Logan Hoggood grabs it behind as Zalak throws it off of his skate, actually, over to Fred Hine. Hine looking to get on the score sheet. Not often he's held off of that here.
Delaware playing pretty conservative with three guys back almost all the time now.
Ryan Kerr trying to get this one out of the zone. It's fought for by Danville, thrown to the ice there. Not sure who that was on the ground. It looked like Zalak. Now Fred Hine with a little bit of space fires a shot. It was stopped up by number 55, Kieran Devine. Devine's going to come the other way with it and throw it all the way down. It's played with a high stick there by Murray, and that one's going to come back here.
Yeah, Delaware doing a good job of hustling after that play because they knew that Murray could not play the puck without causing a face-off at his own end. So they kind of forced the action there, and they'll get the face-off here on the near side of Jesse Gordichuk.
Troy Murray getting a little bit of a laugh in there with the official as he held it up towards his chin like he was saying, this is only how high it was, that's legal. And the referee saying, that was up by your eyes. They both laughed that one off. Pretty obvious high stick there, but he did kind of what he had to, a knee-jerk reaction, as Delaware really pressing in the offensive zone now. Maybe conservative on the back end, but not now, as they head into the Dashers' offensive zone, playing through Mark Anthony Simonetta. Brought around here. And that one shot on to Jesse Gordichuk, lost in the midst of bodies here, but Gordichuk ended up with it swallowed into his chest. Thomas Municello on the original pass there, set up the shot, as he's going to remain out on the ice, as we're going to get a little shift change for Danville. Face off here to the left to Jesse Gordichuk. Delayed puck drop there as it's won by Delaware and pushed further into the zone. Fighting for it in the right-hand corner here, both sides as they wrap it around. On it there, number 28, Thomas Municello. Out there with him, number 44, Mark Anthony Simonetta. As Municello has it now, passes it back to the point man, Litke. Trying to get a stick on it there was Brett Menton. Instead, Delaware with a hard shot from the right, scores! Another goal there for Delaware. They take a 2-0 lead through Mr. Thomas Municello.
Dashers there, not getting on the puck, not playing the man, giving up the opportunity. And Municello coming up firing and puts it in behind Jesse Gordichuk. And suddenly, this crowd and the Danville Dashers bench stunned, down 2-0 with 17:07 left in the third.
Danville in deep trouble here, falling behind 2-0 early on in the third period to the bottom team in the Eastern Conference, conference rivals here. And being waved off of it there was Zalak. Fred Hine steps in to take it. He loses out and it comes all the way back to number 92, Daniel DeCristofaro. DeCristofaro throws it off the boards there to Cutting. Cutting lays it off there for number 3, Evan McIntosh. Oh, a nice back through the leg pass there by Masters. Sets up nicely to the right side of Jesse Gordichuk. DeCristofaro with a point shot, almost redirected by Cutting. Instead, that one hit the ceiling, Dennis. Literally.
Yeah, and scared the heck out of me again because Delaware with another big opportunity there. And Gordichuk just able to get a body part on that one and deflect it up high and out of play.
And taking a look at the official tally on the first goal, the second goal obviously by Municello, Charlie Penns Jr. scored it. It was assisted by Mr. Taylor Cutting and Mr. Eric Masters, three former Danville Dashers combining to get the go-ahead goal here. And that second goal, obviously, by Mr. Municello.
They drafted well.
They did. It was a smart draft, I suppose. This one passed in. Looking for Masters was McIntosh. Instead, it comes to Danville. Zalak going to try and carry it through the zone. He's stopped up there by Charlie Penns.
Delaware again doing a good job of keeping that puck to the outside. The Dashers didn't even have a chance to get an offensive play in.
Delaware down a man there as Charlie Penns actually was making a shift change for Pisano. A shot from the right-hand side for Fred Hine. Aaron Taylor with another shot off of a rocket of a wrister there from the right wing.
Fred doing a good job of following his shot. Good hard shot. Knew he was going to get a good chance at a rebound. He came after it, but Taylor quickly gobbled up that rebound himself.
Daniel DeCristofaro was checking to make sure all his teeth were in. He hit it a little hard, but he's right back up. So good to see him back in the play. Murray, a shot from the right, a nicely aimed shot, but Aaron Taylor uses his shoulder to get away. Fought for along the boards here. Devine trying to poke it out. Danville trying to keep a hold of it. Nick Gullo trying to get a stick on it. He's pushed against the boards there by number 59, Brian Dunford. Nick Gullo getting tied up, his stick tied up. He throws a punch. It's waved off, though, as a good friendly banter, I would say. Barakov on it now from the point. Over to Murray. Murray with a pass to the shot. Gullo with a backhander. Oh, what a beauty that would have been. Aaron Taylor equal to the task, though. Nick Gullo being frustrated there, and he was very stick tied down in that corner. Tension's high here as Danville down 2-0 with 15:36 left to go here in the third period. Potentially the game. We'll see how it turns out. Still plenty of time on the clock. And a two-goal lead, the most dangerous lead in hockey, especially on a road game. Danville with a little bit of possession here. Brusen tries to throw that one around with a backhand. Instead, going to come down to the right wing, and Danville going to have it here again. Oh, a nice stick move there from the right side. Going to try and find some open space. Goal! Who was it on the end of that? Jesse Nair!
Finally, the Danville Dashers cash in.
And the most dangerous lead in hockey, living up to its reputation there, as Danville right back in this one as soon as it seemed Delaware was going to have their way.
That'll get this crowd back into the game, and we're seeing a little more life from the Dashers as well.
And a nicely placed goal there as Danville pulls back a goal, now down just one. As the Danville trainer going to make her way over to the bench here. Looks like they're checking out Devine, but he says he's fine. Heck, you could say he's doing divinely. I'm sorry. Coming back behind the goal here to Jesse Gordichuk. I promise never to do that again.
Those dumb jokes are supposed to be my job.
It just popped into my head. Jesse Nair gets an all-important goal here. How about him lining up in the defensive spot, still contributing the Dashers' only goal so far. That one actually kept in the zone there by Lidke. Maybe not the greatest decision, but he gets away with it here. Coming down the left wing, Delaware. Shot from the point. That one was in the hands of Evgeny Demin and swallowed up by the left-handed glove of Jesse Gordichuk. Nicely. Mitch Atkins on the assist with Jesse Nair putting down the goal at even strength. 2-1 here with 14:50 left to go in the third. Danville team missing a couple players. Alex Palmerville, Ben Bucall, Nigel Slade obviously off for tonight.
Really missed the two defensemen.
Fred Hine coming down the right-hand side here as he fires a shot actually off the leg there. Number 32, Charlie Penns Jr. Nick Gullo on and out. Gullo tries to fight for it along the boards. It's nicely played there by number 5, Evgeny Demin. Quintos back in the defensive slot now actually with Ensor out there. As he shifts back in and Brad Denny comes back out. Now Quintos on the break here. As Quintos is pushed off the puck by Penns, who's had a good showing tonight, including that goal. And that one hard off the boards, bounces right back into the leg of Aaron Taylor, and we're going to have an offensive faceoff here to the left.
Tyler Quintos had his eyes wide looking at that puck bouncing out in front of the net, but Taylor got to it before he could. Otherwise, we would have been tied up.
Delaware now taking the advantage here in terms of total shots, 34-33 with 6 in this third period. Cutting now works it down the left wing here. It gets as far as Danville. Was touched up there by Masters, who has it now. Looking for a little help as he's pressured by two Danville Dashers. And nobody there to get that puck until very late on in the cycle, as Ensor is going to have a foot race with this one with Masters. Ensor wins out, pushes it back around, but just like the last time, the only one there was the forward, and he has to play it back. A shot actually comes off the arm of Jesse Gordichuk. Brad Denny on this one.
Need to get this puck out, guys.
And this one coming back around here. Armstrong kind of coming back on defense to do a little bit of work, but it coughs up. And luckily, Danville, the only one there with it, as Tesserero has it. Gets past one, but loses the puck, trying to keep it and do it himself here as he was touched up by Evan McIntosh. Now Brad Denny having to retreat and do a little more defensive work as this one's fought for. Eric Masters with some good hustle plays there along the boards. Barakov now come the other way and dumps it down. Danville obviously going to get a shift change after that. As Barakov puts pressure on, Atkins might be able to save this one. Instead,
close.
It comes back out to Brian Dunford, who throws it down. He's carrying it across the blue line. A shot goes left and up of Jesse Gordichuk and comes all the way back around to Brousen. Now on the right wing, it's Nair. Nair throws it forward to Atkins. Atkins trying to find Nair or Brousen. Nobody open there. Brousen, a hard slapper off the glass. That one actually ran along the glass and out. That was just a frustration shot there from Brousen. If it had been on target, I'm not sure anybody could have stood in the way. They might have a bullet hole through him.
Yeah, Justin Brousen did a good job of finding the open space, and the puck found him. He came up firing. Dasher's showing that frustration now.
They certainly are here as they're working it behind the goal of Aaron Taylor, pressed to the ground. Goes Mitch Atkins. Atkins with a nice move to get past one. He's still got it as he finds a little space. A wraparound wrister. It's swallowed up by Taylor into the blockers. And, man, Aaron Taylor has been a puck magnet tonight. If he hasn't had the location of the puck, it seems to just fall right into his pads.
Mitch Atkins doing a great job of creating an opportunity where none existed. And all of a sudden, the Dashers had an opportunity. But Taylor's been strong tonight.
Face off to the left of Aaron Taylor. It's knocked out into the middle of the two squads here as it comes back out to the point for Danville. Trying to get a hand on it. There was Quintos instead. It's going to be picked up by Charlie Penz and played out to number 44, Simonetta. Simonetta put into the glass there by Gullo. As a shot swallowed into the chest of Gordichuk, dangerously leaking out there. Another rebound opportunity here. This one going to have to be swallowed up by Gordichuk as looming was Mark Anthony Simonetta.
Wow. Evgeny Demon came up empty again. He just had a good opportunity, but missed the puck by about 3 inches.
The aforementioned Demin in the faceoff circle here. It was one, but it is out of the zone before it's collected by the captain, Charlie Penz, as he's going to fling this one down. No shift change here. Not quite quick enough here as Delaware actually able to get it back in a dangerous situation. A shot from DeCristofaro from out on the right point as trying to fight for it, Nick Gullo. He does. Good hustle play there by Gullo, and he's going to end up with the puck because of it. It is a one-on-three, and the odds are not in your favor. Nice pass there to Quintos. Quintos with a shot off the leg of Penz. A rebound to Atkins, and Quintos almost links up there with Mitch Atkins as it goes off the leg of Charlie Penz on the pass as well as the shot. As threatening here, Delaware now a wraparound opportunity, greatly taken. We're going to have a penalty here for interference. And also Jesse Gordichuk on the ground in pain.
And he got hit hard again. There was a big collision in front of the net.
And also down, Evgeny Demin has been influential tonight for Delaware. He's down and clearly in pain. As we're going to see how this one came up, we'll check our little replay here. Looked like he lost his skate and the two collided there. And he actually just didn't turn the corner fast enough and ran right into Jesse Gordichuk. And both players still on the ground hurt, and there's going to be a penalty come of this as well, as we saw the lineman hand come up there on the far right side. As Gordichuk very shaken up, they might want to get Harley White out there on his skates as he's still sitting on the bench.
Yeah, Harley's getting good and loose on the bench, though.
As that was not a pretty collision in any way here. And hopefully both players can get up. And first up off the ice is Evgeny Demin, who definitely looked like he should have taken the least of that as he skated right into Jesse Gordichuk trying to do a wraparound. In a penalty, the penalty shootout, the shot would have been illegal.
I think he's also going to get to go to the penalty box after having to pick himself and peel himself up off the ice.
Ray Tremblay wants a bigger penalty, but it's going to be 2 minutes to Evgeny Demin. Tremblay is proceeding his case, and probably rightfully so. Your starting goaltender was on a hot streak. You had all the momentum. And a false wraparound shot turns into a football tackle right in front of the net. Jesse Gordachuk being attended to by the trainers here.
Jesse was kind of holding his right hand and trying to flex it out. I wonder if he just kind of got slashed a little bit on the hand as well.
It could be that. It could be pressed up against the bar. There's no telling when those bars come into play. It could be dangerous.
And that's the smallest part of his problem because he took a big hit. He was hurting a little bit of everywhere.
And earlier on in the night, he also took a big hit that caused his helmet to come off. So he's back up and standing, and it's good to see Jesse up and well. As the trainer is escorted over nicely by Sam Turner. And a two-minute penalty assessed to Evgeny Demin here with 11:31 left to go in the third period. A 2-1 game here, Delaware in favor, thanks to that go-ahead goal by Thomas Municiello.
And browsing out there on the ice, wearing that big old C on his chest. Trying to also campaign for a little more of a penalty there.
And there is one thing that I think is often overlooked when it comes to Justin Brousen, and it's how much he means to this franchise. He is a true leader of men out there on this team. He slots into defense. He slots in at center, right wing, left wing. Surprised we haven't ever seen him play goaltender. As we get a little bit of the situation explained here, the line judges get back into play. Jesse Gordachuk going to remain in the game. Is Harley White still over there stretching a little bit, even pressed up against the glass? And
I think the official's doing a good job of giving Gordachuk lots of time to get loose after that collision.
They gave him enough time, and hopefully it doesn't escalate into anything else. We are on a Jenaworth power play, so Danville not going to want to do a whole lot of anything that'll get them into more trouble here.
Except put the puck in the net.
That's the best way to get back at your opposition and the best way to get back at fans, as we saw with Charlie Penns earlier tonight. As Danville wins this faceoff, a crucial one here by Fred Hine on the left wing. A pass there behind the goal of... To goal, Fred Hine! The sharpshooter himself, the bow and arrow celebration as Fred Hine pulls the Dashers even on Friday night action at the David S. Palmer Arena. You can't ask for a quicker power play goal than that from the Boston man himself.
Fred and Linda's kid with a lightning shot finds its way past Taylor, and we're tied.
Did not expect that one to come in. Just went under the left hand of Aaron Taylor, and that one right into the right corner. Clean as you like from Fred Hine.
I was talking with Fred earlier today about how he finds that open space, and he says he just has a knack of sort of circling and finding that open space in the defense. Did a great job there and cashed in.
A whole new game, and like Benjamin Button, we're back where we started from as Delaware on the defense now as Danville takes some momentum after that hit on Jesse Gordachuk. Comes back to haunt Delaware. I almost called him Danbury. Nick Gull on the left wing. He's got Fred Hine again on the right wing. Hine with a shot that doesn't get as far as Taylor's. It's bounced up into the rafters. Comes back down, though. A big hit there laid by Ensor. A bad decision, though. His master's going to come down the left wing with it here. A shot swallowed by Gordachuk.
Nothing wrong with Gordy. He's healthy and makes a big stop.
A big slash there from McIntosh, but doesn't look like anything's going to happen because of it. Fred Hine looks like he wants a piece, and McIntosh going after the likes there of Nick Gullo as they've been going back and forth all night.
Fred Hine, not only a great offensive and defensive player, but he won't take any of that stuff.
A very, very passionate hockey player, I think, is the best way to summarize Mr. Fred Hine, the man from Boston, Massachusetts.
We've already seen him get a Gordie Howe hat trick.
That's true. Now, Delaware, man, I cannot get that out of my mouth straight. Must be the expansion flu.
The Thunder.
The Thunder now going down the left wing here. Danville trying to clear this one out of their defensive zone. Able to do a little bit. Jesse Nayer able to get it back with a backhand. That was a clean pass under the stick there of Evgeny Demin, who went to the penalty box earlier and saw Danville capitalize on it. And now 2-2 here at the David S. Palmer Arena. 10:15 left to go here in Friday night action. The conclusion of the FPHL evening here. Prime time.
Some good opportunities there by Danville. Now turn it over.
Demin over there to Municiello. A hard shot that was wide left of Gordachuk. And it's out to the point here. Delaware threatening. Off the stick of Gordachuk. Handed out there by Murray as that one's recovered by Municiello. He's going to come back around the goal with it, actually, and pass it out to the point here. Oh, a nice effort there by Jesse Nayer. That one's going to be offside, as he did just enough to get that one on and push it over the line before it was touched up by Anthony Pisano. And we're going to have our media timeout with 9:45 left to go.
I think we all need a break after that hot and heavy action the last 5 minutes.
I need a break, that's for sure. 2-2 here with 9:45 left to go in the third period. Dennis, how about the man himself, Mr. Fred Hine? It must be good luck. You interviewed him today.
Yeah, over at Mad Goat. Great visiting with Fred and talking some hockey with him. Just such a nice guy in addition to being a fantastic hockey player. And he does such a good job. He's part of that tight leadership core on this team that just has so many members. But you see it. When you've got a good, strong leadership group like that, you end up with a team where everybody is pulling on the same side of the rope. And we see it time and time again where a shot from Fred Hine that ends up in the net gets some life back in this team, and now we're tied up and the Dashers have had the big advantage on the old momentum here in the third.
This one's going to be fun down the stretch here, and I said it earlier kind of jokingly, Dennis, but this really is prime time, and it's living up to be a prime time game so far tonight. Goalies doing their best. We've had action. We've had physicality. It started off slow, but it's gotten into it here in the third period.
And the Dashers are getting very creative on the playmaking.
Face off here to the left of Taylor. 9:43 left to go in the third period. As Levi Armstrong's the first one to it. He loses it up. We're going to have another penalty here. We'll see who touches it. It's going to be on Danville.
It's going to be on Danville.
And that one's going to be blown dead now as it finds the stick of Brad Denny. We'll see Patrick Zalak getting cued for this one. The official ruling on that penalty to Evgeny Demin was charging, for what it's worth, for those of you wondering.
Good call. They had a lot of options there.
They did indeed have a lot of options. One of them probably could have been a major, a couple of them, and that's what head coach Ray Tremblay wanted. Such luck, and I think he's happy with how it turned out, I would say.
Yep, Zalek with the felon's guilt right to the box. He knew who it was on.
He's usually not one to run away from what he does. I've noticed that over the year. As this one comes out here, Charlie Penz throws that one on. It's stopped up nicely there by Murray. This one going to be thrown out of the zone. Going to have a chance as Tyler Quintos. One-on-one down the right-hand side. He was tangled up there as he tries to shove this one in on Taylor. He's going to hold it behind here. A nice play there by Quintos.
Good job of killing about 20 seconds and a penalty right here.
Heads up play there by Quintos. Going to get the plaudits from Coach Ray Tremblay as he goes in, as Justin Brousen gives him a knuckle touch as well. And Nick Gullo doing much the same here. Delaware going to have to push men forward or risk having this whole penalty given out.
Good job by the Dashers at the beginning of this, PK.
Hard off the foot of Taylor, and that one's brought up along the left-hand side here. Some nice crisp passing here from the Thunder as Pisano unable to hold on to this one and lurking on it. A big hit lay there by Nick Gullo into the side of Municello as he carries it down the right wing. And you know, a hard hit from Nick Gullo, not really going to knock a whole lot of people over, just do enough to get you some time, and that's exactly what happened. A nice stick there and a foot. It's Brousen's out on the open. Brousen down the center. Brousen on the right-hand side. Lost the puck. Swallowed up by his former teammate Aaron Taylor.
Puck just on edge a little bit there and could not make the play and cash in.
And actually on the left-hand side there, that was Artem Efimov Barakov. Noticed it as soon as I called it there. You see, it's quite the size difference there. Although a heads-up play there by Danville. 42 seconds left to go on the serve pro penalty kill. Forgot to mention that. As we are rolling here at the State Farm Arena, or should I say jumping? Is this Wisconsin? Very few people will understand that joke. Anyway, 38 seconds left to go here in the penalty kill for Danville. 8:07 left to go in the third period. As Delaware build it out from the back here, Mitch Atkins applying pressure. Instead, it comes out all the way to Eric Masters. Masters has had a good night tonight. Got an assist on the earlier goal from Charlie Penz Jr. Teaming up with his former Dashers teammate, now Delaware teammate. Not a big name change. Litke on the right-hand side. He passes it through, an errant pass there to Young, but it's actually going to end up with Taylor Cutting, who gets it to Young anyway. Young looking to pick a pass here as Danville on the defensive zone for 7 more seconds and doing a good job at it. It's over to Young right now. Oh, a nice stick check there as we are back to even strength right now as this one played out here. Trying to get a stretch pass connected is Danville.
Close.
Not an icing there as it was close enough as Atkins. That was a huge hit laid there by Zalak, fresh out of the penalty box. Fred Hine on the left-hand wing has a shot. It's deflected there by Masters with a heads-up stick. As Delaware could have numbers, they seem to elect a shift change anyway, though. Instead, a nice defensive effort there from Danville as Gordachuk actually has to stick that one away, and it's off of his own teammate's stick. And a nice move there by number 9, Brett Menton, on the other side as this one comes back to Denny. Denny fires from the point, left-handed glove save. Aaron Taylor as he slides over to make the stop.
Taylor a little surprised that Denny would try that shot from the point, and it almost found its way into the back of the net. Dashers starting to pour on the offense here. Getting very aggressive.
Quintos able to corral this one behind here as we're back to even strength, obviously. And some hard hits being laid now.
Down it goes.
Down and out. We got a delayed penalty. Danville going to have the advantage here as Jesse Gordachuk is off the ice. And Jesse Nayer actually.
Pisano's going to be going to the box.
Make that Sam Turner had it. Oh, dangerous opportunity there. Almost scored on himself.
Wow.
And Sam Turner. That one was 4 or 5 inches away from being in the blue zone. Instead goes into the side of the net and lucky. Dashers, that would have been quite the turn of events if you score on yourself.
Yeah, while the net is empty because you're on that delayed power play. You started a power play there. That was very dangerous.
Even when the other team can't touch the puck, I still don't feel comfortable throwing it inches in front of the ice.
No.
Not the way these goaltenders tear up that ice before the period. Oh, man, crazy stuff here tonight, folks. If you're tuning in with us or if you've been here the whole time, welcome into the Danville Dashers Broadcast Network. Danville now on the Jenneworth Power Play as we are tied up here. Now, crazy turn of events.
Suddenly, Danville could take the edge here when it looked like they were down and out just a few minutes ago.
And Municello applying the offensive pressure there. Coming the other way with it is Tesserero. Nayer with it now. Nayer, Tesserero, Turner, Brousen, Fred Hine out there. Turner with a nice move to get past one. He's got a little space. Alexa pass it off. It comes out of the blue zone. And coming the other way with it, looking to go the other way with it, was Evgeny Demin. Instead, turned over there to Nayer, who gets it back. Nayer down the right-hand side. A shot goes wide left of Aaron Taylor. Fred Hine collects it. Dumps it to Turner. Up and over the boards here and back into play as Nayer has it. A pass in front of net. And this one played out harmlessly to the right wing as sticks collide and the puck takes a mind of its own. With a little vacation for the puck as Justin Brousen picks it up here. 1:03 left to go here in the power play. The Jenneworth power play, 5:30 left to go in the third period. Sam Turner on it now. Tesserero behind the net. Tesserero out in front. Nayer scores! A late goal, Jesse Nayer!
All game long, A.J. Tesserero has been making some nice little cheeky plays with the puck. Just taking a little bit off of the pass. And he did so there, got the puck out to his teammate in a good spot, and all of a sudden, the Dashers have taken the lead.
And absolutely cheeky there by A.J. Tesserero, and well finished by Jesse Nayer, beating Aaron Taylor down to his left. What a beauty that was, and Danville scoring 3 straight here in the third period to come back and take this lead, a 1-goal lead here with 5:24 left to go in the third period. Tyler Quintos coming out to take this faceoff here against number 3, Evan McIntosh. Quintos sent off as soon as he came on. And on it now, number 8, Mitch Atkins. Quintos on it now. He sends this one in. Hard hit there from Taylor Cutting as he's saying hello to his former team in a big way. As Cutting hits his man and the Dasher there on that one. And on the other end of it, Atkins got an opportunity. A shot on to Taylor, swallowed up.
Whoa, Mitch Atkins with a nice play.
I think the only thing you can do is say, wow.
Somebody woke the Danville Dashers up all of a sudden, and they have started to play really good hockey here in the last 5 or 6 minutes.
Jesse Nayer scores his second goal in 10 minutes, and A.J. Tesserero gets his second assist on 10 minutes, and so does Sam Turner. As threatening down to the other end here now is Masters. Masters coming around here as he passes it down the boards. It's intercepted by Levi Armstrong. Levi Armstrong coming down the left.
Nice
finds Barakov on the left-hand side. A drag carries it around the net, trying to shove it in. Can't get it completed, though, as he's pushed off into the boards. But Danville has it at the point. Murray on it. Now he's got a little space off the leg there of Masters. As a big hit laid there in return. Levi Armstrong taking out his old teammate, Taylor Cutting. As Cutting is down, and Masters trying to go at him now.
Good, clean hit. And he got his money's worth on that hit as well.
And Armstrong smiling slightly as he heads to the bench. Eric Masters not happy with that one as he heads to the bench too. And Cutting slow to get up here. We hope he's okay.
Yeah, he took a very, very big hit there. Yes. Seems to be okay, just kind of shaking up a little bit.
I would see this one turning out poorly in the end. We're going to see a fight by the time the weekend ends, probably between those two. And I did call it earlier on in the game.
Yes,
that if we're going to see somebody fight Cutting, it's probably going to be Armstrong, but maybe not as friendly as we thought.
You know, right before that big hit, Levi made a real nice pass to get an opening and give the Dashers a chance at goal number four. So Levi, a tough guy, but boy, his game has really improved this year.
Yeah, no doubt about that. He continues to develop year in, year out here as Ensor pulls it behind the net of Jesse Gordichuk. Ensor coming down the right wing. If Jesse Gordichuk's coming down the right wing, we have a problem. Huge hit laid there. Good hit. As that comes down the right wing, Ensor shakes it off. Nothing bad about that. Just a nice hockey hit.
Yep.
Coming down the left wing here, fighting for it there is Ryan Kerr, who's come back to the ice after a notable departure for a minute there, as Turner has it behind the glass here. Turner, a stretch pass to the right side, finds Fred Hine, who's got no numbers with him, but elects to come back, and if you're going to have somebody controlling the puck in his own defensive zone, Fred Hine, not a bad person to pick.
He's sort of in the middle of a shift changer, too, so good play by Fred.
As he was looking for another shift change, instead it's going to be poked out. Pushed off the puck there. As Danville going to have an opportunity. An open stick there from the left-hand side. Taylor does just enough to get a blocker there. A nice play there on Charlie Penns as Penns was looking for a clean grab off of a popped-up puck and instead was pushed off by Ensor. Now Nayer on it, throws it down into the zone here. Atkins, Nayer browsing out there on offense for Danville. 3:13 left to go here in the third period.
Great stick there by Nahir because that pass would have been wide open for a Delaware chance.
Coming down the left wing here, it's number 28, Thomas Municello, wrapped around out to the point to Devine. Devine, off the right blocker there, lurking was Evgeny Demin, but not able to get a stick on it. Oh, a nice athletic play there from number 28, Thomas Municello. Might be a little bit dyslexic. Me, not Municello. But this one's frozen up. We're going to get an official ruling. I don't know if you saw that one, Dennis.
Yeah, again, I think they said that, I think it was an inadvertent whistle for a high stick. And so they're going to just start off all over here fresh at center ice.
Right in the center ice, third period, 2:45 left to go here. Danville up 3-2 after scoring three straight. And Artem Efimov Barakov showing you a little bit of
hustle.
Why. With the hustle plays.
Great hustle.
Tesserero and Nayer out there with it. Nayer bumped off the puck there nicely by number 3, Evan McIntosh, who's had an active night tonight for Delaware. Sam Turner on this one uses that big body to kind of force his way around, and this one's going to be thrown up. Levi Armstrong, the closest Dasher to it, but needless to say, Kieran Devine much closer for Delaware. McIntosh throws this one down the ice. Sam Turner on it again as McIntosh lays chase. Comes all the way around to Quintos and keeps on going as it evades the stick there. All the way to Daniel DeCristofaro.
Down to 2 minutes left in regulation.
And Danville on it here as this one's flicked up into the air. Going to be a hectic last 2 minutes. You can already kind of feel it. Number 32, Charlie Benz Jr. on it there. Flicked down. Not a whole lot of build-up play going on as Logan Hoggett will grab this one behind the goal. comes out to Fred Hine. Hine gets it out of the zone nicely, just about by an inch or so. And Charlie Penns fires a slapper off the chest pad of Gordachuk. A little bit of a timing issue on that one. And Charlie Penns already scored on one slap shot tonight. Why not have a second? As he's going to be the first one back to this one as well. And it's pushed up along the boards here, coming all the way to number 44, Mark Anthony Simonetta.
Minute 20 left.
A pass to self via Fred Hine there. Oh, a beauty of a save. Jesse Gordachuk almost a full split to get his glove up there to that one.
Wow, I thought he was beat on that one. That shot coming from outside the blue line.
And truthfully, I'm not even sure that would have been on target, but what a beauty. It looked like it was fading a little bit high, as Delaware going to take their timeout here with 1:19 left to go. 3-2, Danville score three goals in a row.
1:19 left. It is not going to be a very calm 79 ticks of the clock here, Nate.
Certainly not. And man, what a game it's been. We complained for a couple periods there that it was a little bit dry, not necessarily what we were up to. Well, as often happens in hockey, everything happens opposite of what the commentary says.
So. It was like two heavyweight boxers just coming out there and trying to measure each other up for the first two periods tonight. Then all of a sudden, boom, just like the camera fell.
Must have been all the noise and tension here in the David S. Palmer Arena. Well, as both sides kind of address the troops, obviously Delaware got a little bit more strategizing to do here. Their head coach, Charlie Penns Sr., not on the bench tonight. We don't know why. But it is a notable absence here. But hey, they're playing pretty well without him there. So maybe he'll decide to coach from the press box.
Yeah, I hope I didn't get everybody dizzy at home there when we dropped down about two floors with the camera.
Well, you gave everybody an unintentional tower of terror drop there.
Scared the heck out of me.
Oh, a dangerous situation there as Gordachuk has to cover that one up with a paw.
Whew. That was a little too nervous there for the Dashers.
As this one's going to come to the left of Jesse Gordachuk here for a faceoff. Mitch Atkins on it with number 5, Evgeny Demin. As it's won by Danville, Murray throws it along the boards. It's going to come all the way out to Anthony Pisano. 1:08 left to go here in the first period.
Good job.
Thrown ahead. They're going to have an opportunity here with an open net as Nayer's trying to fight for it. Oh, nicely held off there by DeCristofaro. On the right-hand side, Danville. Goal!
Yes!
From the right-hand side, Mitch Atkins.
Mitch Atkins doing a good job, as he always does, of getting lost along the boards. Collects that puck and fires it into the empty net. And that should do it, folks, although still 55.8 left. And the way this third period is going, it's not time to settle in and be happy for the win yet.
No, definitely not. It's very interesting here now being up two goals. That's four goals in a row for Danville here. Down the stretch is Patrick Zalak in the faceoff circle going up against Evan McIntosh with 55 seconds left to go here in the period. Looks like this one might be wrapped up for Danville after that one.
They were very stealth on removing the goaltender. I didn't see
they were.
What happened.
I did not see him come off, but more importantly, Mitch Atkins and Jesse Nayer did. As Mitch Atkins rewarded for a lot of hustle plays here in the last couple of weekends, especially at home. Good to see him grab one. Oh, that's another dangerous shot there. It was Armstrong.
Oh, here we go.
And Pisano has a hold of Armstrong by his head as he was pushed into the boards by Pisano. And then helmet properly grabbed. Now Charlie Penns dragging down. Actually, Taylor Cutting there on the other end wearing that patented number 20.
Yeah.
As he's taking down Seth Ensor. And Ensor's got his helmet off. Let him go at it.
Ensor was not happy with that move. And now another little move there with the right-handed. Oh, here we go.
And here we go.
Now Ensor.
It was Ensor and Pisano who wanted to have at it. Referees quickly see that one out as there are sticks, gloves,
I think
hats
they're still going to meet.
All over the ice, Levi Armstrong wants to fight Pisano and is taunting Pisano with the gorilla walk. They better get that large man to the bench before we have a real brawl here.
I think the going to send him right to the locker room, but they're going to have to have a little escort around the Dashers here.
As he gets a good wave from the Danville crowd, as that's Anthony Pisano, who had a big part in this Delaware defense so far tonight, is thrown off the ice. I don't know if they're going to bother assessing a penalty. Interesting, they should. Technically, it was a penalty, but with this game 30 seconds left to go, it would seem a little bit arbitrary to a point.
Well, I kind of think if they're going to be consistent on how they usually call it, he should get an instigation penalty.
Yeah.
And Danville should finish this game up on a power play.
Yeah, and a lot going on there is Levi Armstrong and Charlie Penn's now talking about it.
It's a lot of discussions that are going on, and I think we're going to see this carry over into tomorrow night as well.
That one's certainly a friendly discussion there between Penns and Armstrong, two former teammates. And I have not met a soul that does not like Charlie Penns Jr., a nice guy, also a DJ in his spare time.
I didn't know that.
Very fun fact for you. I think of DJ Red Fox or something similar to that.
Good choice of music by Tommy B as the referee send a Delaware Thunder player
smiling about it too. Oh boy, what a mess the referees have on their hands right now as both captains gather around to get the official word. And you know, I figured we'd be done a little bit earlier than this, judging by how the first two periods went, but
30 seconds left, and I don't think it's over yet. I think we might see a little more in the way of rough stuff here.
You do kind of have to wonder exactly what's going to happen here.
Seth Ensor is being sent off as well.
Ensor is going to make his way off the ice here.
And Levi Armstrong, maybe. Nope, he's staying. So there's probably that's the next fight to happen.
As Cutting makes his way to the bench, though, so no harm, no foul on that one. And the final ruling here. A 2-minute minor for roughing and a game misconduct. And that was going on Anthony Pisano. That one pretty clear, pretty easy, I would say, as we head down the stretch here. Just 27 seconds left to go. And an accidental high stick there catches the mouth of Patrick Zalak. Definitely nothing malicious in that one, though. That was the least malicious thing we've seen in the past 30 seconds.
Inside of 15 to go.
And some big hits sure to come tomorrow night. Probably two or three fights, judging by how this has gone. As Delaware going to hold this one behind their net to run the clock out. 3-2-1. As Jesse Gordichuk, the last player to touch the puck. A huge comeback win for the Danville Dashers. A 4-straight goal comeback. One empty netter and three even strength, or two even strength and one power play, as tensions escalate late in the game between these two sides, as Danville happy to come away with a win after falling down 2-0 early in the third period. Tomorrow's game is gonna be an interesting one.
Danville Dashers were almost looking like they were sleepwalking through the first couple of periods tonight. Then all of a sudden got that offense going. All it took was that first goal to get them going. Once that happened, they took this game over and sent Delaware home and without the win, and sending the fans home very, very happy as they salute this crowd here at the David S. Palmer Arena. And the best part is we get to do it all again tomorrow night.
All smiles all around there from the Dashers, even after a bit of scrappiness in the end.
So I think Seth Ensor's got to come back out maybe to get one of the stars.
Yeah, it's definitely a possibility.
Jesse Nahair's got to be Jesse Nahair's got to be the number one star tonight.
He will be the number one star. He did have the go-ahead goal. Also worth noting, A.J. Tesserero and Sam Turner both with two assists on the night. Mitch Atkins, obviously, the open goal.
A.J. deserves a star. He had some really nice plays to create some chances, and they finally cashed in on a couple of them.
And they might give Tesserero the benefit of the doubt on this one. The veteran turning in a very crafty performance to lead this team back from a 2-0 deficit. He had assists, and crucial assists, might I add, on both goals here to tie it up. And then a pretty interesting night tonight as well to decide these stars, as Mitch Atkins also had 2 points. He did have an assist earlier on that Jesse Nayer first goal. But overall, I'm probably going to think it'll be a battle between those four, I would say. Atkins, Tesserero, Turner, and Nayer, with the two goal scorers getting the benefit of the doubt and one of the two assist makers, you would think.
Home ice advantage, we might even get to have the advantage of sweeping the Stars.
I would think we would probably sweep the Stars here tonight. As the third star goes to Sam Turner, as that one was expected here tonight. Did very, very well on the evening. 2 assists, 2 points. This one's going to go to A.J. Tesserero for the second star, which means the Danville Dashers are going to sweep the Stars.
Really well deserved there for A.J.
And Jesse Nayer had the go-ahead goal in a big night here in Danville. And he's going to get the first star here tonight for his troubles.
Well deserved.
As he gives a stick away, too, on the way out.
Yeah.
And all fun and all family, all friends here at the David S. Palmer Arena tonight, as the Danville Dashers score 4 in a row, led by the heroic efforts of A.J. Tesserero, Jesse Nayer, Sam Turner, Mitch Atkins, and Fred Hine. Worth noting, I know that's more than four, but it's worth mentioning those assists. What a beauty and what a comeback here for Danville heading into the weekend finale tomorrow against Delaware. It'll be interesting to see if Delaware does return any of the players they were missing tonight, as well as Danville actually returning a few players. We may see a lineup change depending on how things shake out. We'll see. There's a lot of questions to be answered tomorrow, including, will we see a fight? I'm going to go ahead and answer that one with a yes. I think we'll see a fight, maybe two, maybe three. But if the referees are as good and as quick as they were tonight to jump on it, we might not see any. They did a great job tonight. Worth the tip of the cap. We always are quick to criticize, so we might as well be quick to praise, too.
They kept the peace in this game, because there was a good chance that we'd see things erupt a lot earlier than they did, and did a very good job, called a very tight game tonight, which kept things in order, and the Danville Dashers woke up in that third period, Nate, and really turned it out, and they showed what they can do. And I have a feeling we're going to see them come out tomorrow night playing a lot more from the beginning of the game like they did at the end of the game tonight.
Yeah, I do kind of wonder if Ray Tremblay was on him in that third intermission, because even then they let up that second goal. It'll be an interesting night tomorrow night. Make sure to join us here at the David S. Palmer Arena. It's going to be really fun. It's going to be an interesting night tomorrow night. Obviously, a special event. It's Cartoon and Faith and Family Night presented by Robinson Chiropractic. Come dressed up as a Toy Story character and get an out-of-this-world gift. So I don't know what that means exactly, but I'm going to be on the lookout for those. There will be prizes for best costumes. As always, a lot going on here tonight and a lot going on here tomorrow in downtown Danville. You're never going to regret coming out to a game, especially not between these two sides. Come see some familiar faces from last year's team as well. Probably get into a fistfight tomorrow night. And, that's going to about do it. Dennis, anything you want to add at the top of the broadcast here?
Maybe the prize tomorrow night will be a trip to infinity and beyond.
I'm assuming it's got to be something Buzz Lightyear.
Pretty good.
I'm assuming you're right on that. Well, for Dennis Michelson, I've been Nate Williamson. Hope you had a great night tonight. We'll be back tomorrow in Federal Prospects Hockey League primetime, another game between the Thunder of Delaware and the Dashers of Danville. Well, for everyone here at the Danville Dashers organization, all the fans, friends, family, and staff, to players and coaches, thanks for tuning in with us. We will see you all again tomorrow.